Hello and good evening. My name is Rob, aka Lantern Noir, and I am here to play some Dungeons and Dragons, in particular Waterdeep Dragon Heist, with some amazing friends. And so welcome to everyone that's already hanging out as we warmed up into this. Thanks for coming by. Ari, we hope you're feeling better. And we're glad you're here to hang out to see what happens in tonight's game, which should be a good one. It's been quite an adventure so far, which we'll recap after our introductions. I am going to let, we're going to go around the table. Introductions include who you are, where we find you on the internets, if you are on the internets, who you're playing tonight. And then I think what we need is, what does your character hate the most about the winter? The one thing that sticks out is I like winter, but... That feels like our best thing to have in there tonight. So, Liz, if you'd be ever so kind as to lead off our roundtable of introductions.
Hi, I'm Liz Tighe. You can find me at any place where you find Motor City Irish Dance. So I know we have some things on Facebook and YouTube, and we'll see where we go from there. We'll be all over town on St. Patrick's Day. And I'm booking now, so if you need some dancers, hit me up. I'm playing Lorelei, who is a rogue half-elf entertainer. So my goal in life is to annoy my family, the elven side, of course, for whom I was never quite, well, elven. So I've gone quite the opposite direction and prefer to slum and strum and sing and seduce my way through the world and be as offensive to them as possible. So what I hate the most about winter is I get mud on my boots and clothing, and just the slushy dampness of it all is very unattractive, and I don't like it.
That tracks. And then we'll head over to Malik.
Hey, I'm Paul, aka Malik. I'm playing Drumir Greyblade. You can find me on Twitter at Paul Jajo on Twitter. It's hard to spell. Don't worry about it. It's linked somewhere, I'm sure. The thing Drumir hates the most about winter is that oftentimes when he's skulking about, he leaves very obvious footprints in the snow. That can be very problematic when you're trying not to be found.
Okay, and that takes us around to Spinnyhelm.
I am Jeremy, aka Spinnyhelm, and I'm playing Nala, the Disney princess trapped in an alternate reality. What she would hate the most about the winter is snow getting in her fur. It was not something she really had to deal with when she was just exclusively a Disney princess. But now it gets in there, it gets cold, it gets wet. But it's something you get used to.
And last but absolutely not least, Arwen.
Hi, I'm Arwen. I'm playing Chrysanthemum Coriolis, the Trickery Domain Cleric. And Chrysanthemum, there's not a lot that she hates, because hating is just not really something that she enjoys doing. But if she had to pick something, it would be the snow, because it's just annoying to have to tunnel everywhere unless you have a bigger friend to dig you out. She makes the best of it because snowball fights and snow angels. But she really doesn't like having to dig her way through the snow to go basically anywhere.
There we go. And my name is Rob. You can find me here at twitch.tv/lanternnoir all the time. And I hate scraping my car every morning. That's my thing I like the least about the winter. So as the DM, all that time standing there scraping the car doesn't help me plan for a game or anything else fun. It's just scraping the car off. Okay. So, small bit of housekeeping. The Book of Fate is ready. If anyone would like to contribute to it, the party has 2 rerolls to kick off things. And there are reminders when we're in this mode of the commands you have available to you. I've also turned on the chat controls so you can access the camera and accent a particular player if you want to. So that's currently turned on. I think it's DH cams is the command to bring up the specifics. And I don't have the, yes, DH cams. I don't currently have that on the scroll yet. But that'll give you a 10-second highlight of that particular player. What we've been doing, so let's get everybody up to speed. They rescued a guy who had been kidnapped by the Zents and the Xanathar Guild, who was confused for another guy who was supposed to be kidnapped by one or both of them. The kidnappings happened because allegedly that Rainier Neverember knew of where his father had hid a massive stash of gold coins, somewhere in the ballpark of 500,000 gold dragons. Of course, Rainier didn't know anything, as one often doesn't know when your father is embezzling from the city. But they parted in good terms and, as compensation for their work, inherited a tavern. Yeah, we'll just say that. Inherited a tavern. They restored the tavern, a little this old house on it, as it were. Bob Vila would never have taken that kind of job. But they restored the tavern, got all back up and running. When one mid-afternoon, a fireball goes off just outside said tavern. Hey, Estaki. They tracked the source of the fireball to a nimblewright, who they then tracked to a house out in the North Ward. They also noticed that one of the people killed in the fireball blast had had something taken from his body, and that thief had run off in the same general direction. Our last session, the party decided to infiltrate the Gralhund estate. And Arwen's already, oh yeah.
It was fine. Everything was fine.
The house full of
nobody
bamboozles.
Nobody died and nobody got arrested. That's about the best you could say for that operation.
It's a success.
Yes. And to those, by the way, that have not yet had the chance to play with Liz, I'm just going to put this thought out there. When confronted with evil, she chose to run deeper into the house instead of out of the house.
Those dogs were really freaking scary, okay?
Just in case you're wondering, is she the type of person that runs out of danger? Not really. I won't say she Leroy Jenkins'd it, but...
Tactical retreat forward.
No, it really wasn't. It was a dive under a dining room table, but it all worked out.
It all worked out. Unfortunately, what you left the villa with is the knowledge that the Stone of Gollor does exist. It was briefly in the Gralhund estate before it was sent away for safekeeping by the mistress of the house. She sent her nimblewright out with it so that it would not end up in the particular hands of whatever gang was attempting to fight their way in. In that case, a lot more of the Xanathar Guild. And
a statue. I got a statue.
You got a statue. Yes. Yes. If I recall correctly, Lorelei found Lord Grelhun's secret naughty cubby.
Yes. We found a few naughty things.
Oh.
One of which now decorates my room. Great statue. Very artistic.
It's important to appreciate the arts.
That's right.
Is that how that works?
Probably.
Yes.
Is that how that works? Appreciate the arts.
I think so.
Okay, so we pick up tonight. You have all had the opportunity to, well, you've regathered, you've connoitered, and you have decided that you need to set out to find exactly where this thing ended up, I assume. I mean, clearly you don't have to go figure out where the key to a vault with 500,000 gold dragons ended up.
Adventure.
It's worth, you know, let's just investigate just to see how, I mean, if it gets crazy, maybe we don't, but 500,000 gold dragons is a lot of money. It'd be a shame if it were to just disappear.
Plus, fireball, we can't allow that kind of thing.
Yeah, that was a dick move. It's about the safety of the community.
Yes,
that we're trying to invest in with the money that we're buying so we can make a nicer place.
Because we provide a public service here.
For the community. Yeah.
Yes.
Exactly.
I like this guy.
And it just sounds like fun.
Also bad.
Well, yeah.
They justify their pillaging of wealth as a means to safeguard the society. These people are so interesting up here. It's just wonderful.
Drumir might have a career in politics after this.
If not, he can buy one. I will also point out, before we get too deep into tonight, that through a strange twist of fate and scheduling, we have two rogues, a cleric of the trickster god, and a random dark elf druid.
Oh, this
is going to go well. It's going to be great.
To you, party balance. We say this.
Exactly. The party only needs to be balanced if there's, you know, actually there's no reason for the party to be balanced. As long as we're having fun. I thought I had something clever to say there, but it turns out I didn't.
Luck goddess, technically. Really?
Listen, for a heist.
I picked Timora.
Two rogues, a trickster cleric, and a druid.
Yeah, right. Sounds like the right team.
That's a power. That's a stacked team. Balance be damned.
That's right. Intelligence and dexterity win every time.
The scary part is if we had all of your wisdom bonuses together, I think we're in debt.
I'm in the positives. I bring the positive wisdom.
I think I'm neutral.
Strength was also my dump stat. Actually, if anything, we should be in an exceptionally wise group. A druid, a cleric, and two rogues who didn't dump it.
Yeah, one rogue did because one the rogue that whipped it up wasn't paying that close attention to it. High charisma, low wisdom. I'm pretty sure that's the character you were going for, Liz.
It was, in fact.
I mean, it worked with the guy last week. You had a pretty good conversation with him.
What was his name again?
Lord something, I think.
Lord something or the other.
I was thinking of the dude at the club.
Lord cowering in the back room?
Oh. Yeah.
I think she was more into the valet.
Well, yeah, but the Lord has more information. So I can be nice to him.
We got a decent amount of information, all things
considered. And I really think intelligence outweighs wisdom anyway. Wisdom can be, you know, wisdom errors can be outrun.
I could go 50-50 on that one.
Ah, well. Done is done.
Running can be avoided. Running can be avoided with wisdom sometimes.
Yeah,
I mean, that sounds like planning, and that's just
or a last-minute disguise self.
There we go. Quote 953.
Oh, well.
We'll put that one into the
archives. If I was wise, I would have stayed home with the elves, but there we have it.
That's fair.
There's wisdom in exploration and experience. Maybe not safety, but, you know, wisdom.
Loss of safety.
Do we have any information about where this? Oh, gee, what is it called again? The little fire thing.
The nimblewright.
Nimblewright. All I could think was Mephit. I'm like, nope, wrong, annoying fire creature.
The nimblewright is the mechanical man thing.
We have a tracker, don't we? You guys didn't.
Yeah, it was like a flower.
It was an umbrella, wasn't it? Something like that.
It looks vaguely umbrella? Like one. But yes, you could use it to track him.
Let's do it.
Polly, thank you for hosting us. We appreciate the host tonight. You set out. There's a bit of, like, for a while, you got a little bit, you have to, like, redirect. Because the nimblewright starts taking you back towards the Temple of Gond.
Right, and which it only tracks one at a time.
Only marginally useful, because that's a nimblewright you already know about.
Yeah, probably not the same one.
Right, in fact, it takes most of the late morning after the first group comes back from the North Ward to say, hey, yeah, well, we found the thing. Before, you know, it's well into mid-afternoon before you're able to, as a group, find an area where you're starting to pick up a different nimblewright and start tracking it. Thus, this is the party we have, and they've all had a long rest.
Nice.
Problem solved.
Problem solved.
That's...
Seems the city's narration comes nimblewrights, though. That seems like a problem.
Yeah. you start to get a pretty good track on its location. You can, after a few, maybe an hour or so, you notice it's moving. As it's continuing.
Where does it seem to go?
We can continue to track it. Added by one other complication in that for midday, late midday, actually, I would say, it's becoming incredibly dark. The storm is starting to kick into high gear. And what was just a chilly afternoon is becoming one of those, every so often you find yourselves pressed against the wall of the wall of the street just to get out of the direct wind as much as you can.
Brutal.
Of course, and
lovely.
The standard flurries, those moments where you can't see all the way down an alley as you passed it because the snow's coming down between the buildings. It's a fun walk.
Somebody want to hold my hand so I don't blow away down the street?
I can't stand it.
You make your way out into the... He said, double check it doesn't work exactly this thing again. It'd be nice if they gave me a location on it. Just out past the edge of town. You come up to one of the gates and you've got something picked up. And it seems to be pointing at an old windmill just past one of the gates along the coastline. It's going to take you outside of the city briefly.
All right. So to recap for myself and the listeners and the viewers, since I wasn't here last time, this is the nimblewright that has the MacGuffin that finds its, that like, tracks us to the vault, I think.
That's the allegation.
Right. And then that nimblewright was sent away by the owners of the house which was doing gang warfare or something.
Was connected to the gangs, yes.
They were connected to the gangs, maybe not working for them, but certainly pursued by them.
Correct.
Right. Okay.
Oh, how big is a nimblewright?
It's a human.
Okay.
But human-sized.
Human-sized.
Got you.
Mechanical man.
Thin and giant wild. One, right?
I mean, that wouldn't... It'd hardly be nimble, would it?
Well, we did... Yeah, I mean, there was a giant one that, like, put dents in roofs, right? The one that dropped the fireball?
I thought it was the regular size, just heavy.
Yeah. It's just it's stepping on those things because it's got those thin little feet. They kind of
got you.
You know, it's kind of like why
this whole time I thought it was giant. I was like, why? How could we not find this giant thing? It must be hiding somewhere in plain sight.
Mechanical Godzilla. Funny.
I thought it was small.
Together, you were correct.
On average, we had the right idea.
Why not? Both?
Right. Well, you know, it's that wisdom thing again. You just
right.
Well, let's see. It's a little bit dim, right? You said.
Yes.
So it might be easy enough to approach without being seen, at least perhaps with my new skulker feet, as it were. But I wouldn't know if that would count as lightly obscured. But either way,
everyone is lightly obscured.
Excellent.
Including the other team.
Oh no.
Oh.
So
another team.
So we could definitely try and approach sneakily and just fall back to combat if things go sideways, or pretty much any other direction than straightforward. Go in there, see if we can find the thing, see if we can assess who's there and what kind of resistance we might be encountering.
Okay. As you creep up towards the windmill, a couple of things catch your eyes immediately. The windows are covered up where there is glass. It's been painted over with some kind of a black pitch. Most of the windows in the windmill are covered up with boards and planks. The top of it, where the actual blades would be, is just standing there like an old tower, more than an actual functioning windmill.
Has seized in the somewhat windy storm that's picking up.
A bit more like no one has used it as a windmill in some time. And the wood likely rotted and snapped.
Gotcha.
Months ago, if not years.
I would not be pleased to see this.
All things fallen into disrepair. Seems to be a running theme with this sort of town.
What sort of entrances are there to this?
There are a couple of doors on the ground floor. Because it's the main tower, and there's a structure that comes off to support like a resident of some kind. So if they had like maybe some farmers that had lived in it, they'd live in the building attached. As you approach, you can see that there's a wagon with an old horse standing in front of it, parked near one of the doors. And the driver's kind of like huddled up right against the door itself, just waiting.
I'm going to guess that it'd probably be less complicated if he didn't see us.
Or we nab him, find out what he's doing.
So true, we could do that. I could try if you want.
I vote yes.
Sure. All right, I'm going to try to sneak over and get a surprise grapple on him and see if I can't flap my hand over his mouth, put a blade to his back and say, hey, I'd be real quiet right now, and I've got a couple questions for you.
Okay, roll me the stealth with
you
advantage.
You want advantage on, yeah.
Oh, he's already got it thanks to the weather conditions.
Gotcha. Okay.
There we are. 16.
16. No problem. You totally get up on him. He's and just like, there's like a tap, tap, and then grab.
Yeah.
He's like, whoa. Whoa.
I say, I'd be real quiet right now if I were you. I got a couple of questions you might want to answer for me. What's in this windmill?
Butcher shop.
Butcher shop?
Butcher shop.
You seen any mechanical men around here?
Nope.
You sure?
Yep. Can't see much out here, but no.
You connected with the Xanathar Guild or the Zentarum?
Nope. Just do deliveries.
Do I believe him?
Roll me an insight. Yeah, no.
22.
He's like totally connected with somebody.
I'm going to rummage in his wagon while he's being questioned there.
Give me a stealth check. Unless you just want to like climb up into it. Are you trying to do it sneakily?
Oh, no. Thanks anyway.
Okay. So the other rogue. You missed. That's sleight of hand.
What? Oh.
Is it different?
Sorry.
Before you roll again, is your bonus different?
I'm sorry. What?
Oh, yeah.
It's even worse. It is different. Whatever.
Wow. You went the wrong direction.
Yeah. Well, you know, trying to be honest here.
I feel like that's what happened last week too.
I rolled terribly last week.
Happening. I'm getting flashbacks.
Technically,
I have my own actual dice. Can I just use those? Because they like me better.
But then we lose all the fun of sharing all of this. We're going to take the 14 minus 2.
You know, it's fine. 12. He can know I'm rummaging in his crap because he can't do anything about it. So
he really can't.
Yeah, I was about to say, what's he? Hey, don't go in my stuff.
Yeah.
Could be someone else.
Please stop doing that with my stuff.
In the back of the wagon, you find a couple of sets of manacles. Some lengths of rope, some large sacks that are kind of half folded up, half tossed in. And when you pick one up, it's like, it's 7 feet long.
Concern?
About, you know, yay wide.
Huh. I'm sorry, Paul, what's your character's name?
Drumir.
Drumir?
Yeah, let me update my name in Zoom.
Drumir, look what I found. This looks like a perfect size for that guy.
Wow. That seems...
And some shackles.
Oh, shackles too. Yeah. That makes perfect sense for things you'd need for a butchery, doesn't it, my friend?
Absolutely.
Those are my girlfriends.
Great. Yeah, somehow I'm doubting that you'd be dragging them all the way out here.
She left them there.
We'll get you all ready for her. Let's go, buddy. Here you go. Toss the shackles to... Drumir.
Yeah, I say we try to knock him out. He is. Oh, actually, why don't I say, listen, pal, my patience is running quite thin, and pretty soon, your blood is going to be quite thin all over the ground unless you fess up.
I'd like to
roll intimidation.
Yes, you are going to roll intimidation.
Excellent, innate.
You're a little damp and scruffy looking.
I promise. Just don't hurt me. I'll explain. Just give me a second. I promise. I'll explain. Just give me a minute.
Start explaining.
No, it's all legitimate. I don't know nothing about nothing that nobody's doing. I'm just a delivery man. I just drop off meat, pick up meat. That's all I do.
Live meat.
What kind of meat?
You know, meat.
6 foot tall, 180 pound meat.
Last one was like more of $170.
Mm-hmm. Right. I look to Liz, see if she has anything else she wants to ask. All right. I'm going to,
Oh, who's inside?
At that moment, you hear the sound of like the clacking noise of large nails on cobbles, on like stone rocks inside the windmill.
Oh.
Like hooves or nails?
More like claws.
Oh. Jump down and stand against the wall up to the side of the door.
Yeah, drag the guy next to me.
Weapons out.
Reasonable. As you do, the door kind of like pops open into the thing. And this dragonborn kind of like pulls himself up and out the door. And he's got this bundle over his back. And he's got another one under his arm. And he comes right out and just heads straight to the wagon. Goes, right, we have a delivery for putting over on the east side. And you can take this pile of crap back to the Temple of Gaun for all I care.
Do we have time to react?
Absolutely. He goes walking right past you. Doesn't even see you.
Dude. So I'm behind him?
At the moment.
Lovely. I wish to jump on his back, wrap my legs around, arms around neck, blade to neck.
Nice.
Okay. Yes, more tackling, because Rob loves grappling mechanics.
They're super cool, aren't they?
They're super, yeah, or something. Let's see here. Why would you? I don't even know why I'm surprised. The day will come where I am not surprised by Liz's choices.
Oh, well.
You know what today is? Why would that happen? Today is not that day. Okay.
You invited me.
I did. I did.
Carolyn, I'm old school. I've been playing this game for a lot of years.
Oh, we're not playing that game tonight, hon. We are not playing that game tonight. We'll have you come on old time happy hour at the Old Timer Tavern sometime.
Sounds good.
And we'll play the game then.
Okay.
Make a mugging check.
A mugging? What the heck?
No. That's from chat. A mugging check. What is a mugging check?
It sounds like something in second edition.
That fell under acrobatics.
That sounds like something they put into 3.5. It sounds like a feat combo.
You know, you get advantage and you get to add your proficiency and your skill bonus. So,
is that how that works?
I mean, every time we kill something, we take everything that's on it. So,
I've reduced the number of skills. They combined a couple.
Yeah,
this is true. Okay. I don't have a great graphic for. Oh, I do. Someone actually made a graphic for him.
Isn't that neat? That's one of the nice things about modules, is like you'll encounter a character and someone's made fan art.
I know, which is great because I wanted to put it on the combat tracker.
Oh no!
Oh.
Well,
that's not so good.
You thought I was stalling just to stall?
I mean, you know.
You didn't think I was stalling to put stuff on the combat tracker?
There's always a purpose to the stalling.
Okay, so what is this AC? Okay, that's a successful acrobatics check to jump on him. That is your surprise action. What is Drumir doing in the surprise round?
I'm gonna interpret his conversation as not exactly fessing up. So I do not take too much of a. I'm not terribly upset as I stab him with the blade as combat is about to start. I did say that he'd start bleeding if he didn't fess up, and he didn't exactly come clean. So I think we're good on that. Stab.
Stab. Awful neutral. It's always stab.
Where are the other two of us at this point? Like we didn't go up to the windmill. Where are we in relation to the windmill?
I would say you are within reach to get into the combat. There's a wagon. There's the dragonborn wearing the rogue, the half elf rogue, and the dwarf rogue is just a short distance away, murdering a guy.
Are we within earshot? Can we hear what's going on?
Yes, okay. you are in this combat as it starts.
Okay.
So I do need a quick initiative roll.
Oh, he looks so cool.
Hang on, let me put that back up here. I'm going to switch to combat mode. We are not yet using Owlbear Rodeo, so I'll just turn that off for now. Oops, and turn that off for now.
Sure, now I roll a defense score.
And while you're rolling, I'm going to do a quick... Yeah, let's add that in. I'll just put that right there. Boom. There, that looks smexy. All right, how did we do with those initiatives? Lorelei is acting on... Wow. See, you can roll just fine digitally when you have
to. When I'm not about to die.
Is that how that works?
When the pressure's not on, you can roll just fine.
Exactly. When death is on the line, I roll terribly.
Okay.
That was not a quote from the princess.
I don't believe you.
I mean, honestly, think about it. The surprise round, putting the dagger directly into his spine.
I'm sure he was
kind of on our side. He just kind of.
Yeah. You do have him in a grapple. You can stabby him. You can leap off before he turns around and has at you. You have lots of options.
Hands up! Demon spawn.
You're going to intimidate him.
Yes, I am.
I would love scary. To see that roll.
Okay, then. Back to crap. I mean, I do have a blade to his throat.
You do. As he's like clawing at you and swatting at your arm and not completely cricket with this plan. Dremir, what are you doing?
I'm going to stab this guy.
That seems reasonable.
He's not playing.
Would you like me to make an attack? Or
yes. Yes, I would, if you're going to.
Do I get advantage because I got him grappled?
Oh, the dude that you just murdered on your surprise action? No, he's dead.
Oh, okay.
No, by this guy, I thought you meant like the dragon.
The person who's still alive.
Yeah, I mean, you know, if that's where we're at. Yeah, yeah. I drop the body down, flip the dagger in my hand, and go to like do an overhead strike.
Okay.
Roll here. 21.
Jeez. Roll all of your damage, stinking rogues.
Yep. 16 points as I find a gap in the armor as he is flailing about with... Did you say you're a half-elf or a halfling?
Half-elf.
Half-elf, okay. So as he has a half-elf on his shoulders or otherwise on his back.
Yeah, we have to make sure that we have a party where everyone can see in the dark except the cleric.
It's
critical that the cleric not see where anything's happening, or that everyone has to have a light just for the cleric.
I mean, it makes for some good RP moments.
Wait, what is Drumir?
Drumir's a dwarf.
Excellent.
Yes, we have a half elf, a dwarf, a dark elf, and a half
quiet dwarf. What a novelty! I love this.
It's I love being able to see in the dark and sneak in the dark. The idea of sneaking around with the torch seems counterproductive. Plus, I get to play off the very logical, like tradition-minded individual who's, you know, a rogue. He went to Dwarven College for wealth acquisition. He has a degree.
I love this.
He's a really fun character to play.
Darn it. Well, you know what? We are going to go crazy.
And elves don't like dwarves, so I might be your new best friend.
Maybe. We're a bit untraditional.
I might try.
Exactly.
I might be your new best friend.
You know what'll piss off the elves? I hang out with a dwarf.
Great. My family will hate this. And it's really fun.
But what would they hate more than that? But hanging out with a dark elf. I mean, like, literally, you've handpicked the most, like, ridiculous people to spend time with.
It's getting better and better. That is also a really good point.
At a certain point, Chrysanthemum's going to take this personal.
Yeah, I was going to say, Drumir's my best friend. I'm going to have to fight you for that.
Speaking of fight, the Dragonborn reaches back, grabs Lorelei by the scruff of the neck, and just throws her against the wall of the windmill.
Ow.
He's definitely thrown caution to the wind in so doing. Really? As he grabs this cleaver off of his belt that, I mean, he might use it as a cleaver, but it's about the size of Chrysanthemum's body. Like her torso. Just perspective.
Oh.
Well, I tried being nice, and that's over now.
You tried very briefly.
You jumped on him and tried to stab him.
I mean,
he did not surrender, so anything that happens now is his fault.
Ah, yes. Yeah. He had his chance. I get it now.
Okay, so Lorelei takes 7 from the impact on the wall.
Ow.
And it turns to the druid to do something interesting.
So what is this dragonborn wearing? Is he wearing like armor?
Light armor, if that. It's more of like he's got like, you know, leather pants, an apron. He's big.
And the weapon, what was the weapon like?
A really big meat cleaver.
Ever played Dark Souls?
Yeah, I would like, or like, you know, the butcher from Diablo 3.
Yeah.
Cool. I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to get in there. Let's see. What are my spells again? I'm like, I want to do heat metal, but like, I don't know if that'll be like great on a butcher's knife. Because then also he'd have a hot butcher's knife that he could hit me with.
Right, but he could also drop it. He could also, like, he's not wearing armor, is he?
Shrink leather and just shrink his armor, that'd be great.
I actually don't have the shrink leather spell. I don't know if it's in this version. I think I will just...
You call yourself like, a dark elf. Know. A dark elf without shrink leather. How do you think they get into them? Into those
You know what? I never thought of that. Like,
you wiggle just in, like, and then you cast it, and it's like
shrink leather. Yeah, look, perfect.
Shrink wrap pants.
Look, I'm not like other elves. Okay,
that's true. You're not like other dark elves.
That's not me. I'm gonna try to cast hold person on the. We're fighting him. There's no reason for that. Never mind. I'm just going to go ahead and turn into a dire wolf and bite him some more. Do
Take
the
him
bites.
Down!
What was that? That is...
I like this went from 0 to 60 real fast.
I know. It's like, and then we got a sneak attack, and now we have a wolf biting at his heels.
Yeah, he's not having a great day.
Yeah. I thought it was just going to be a normal delivery, man. Like, what's going on?
Yeah, he's just delivering things. With this Those things group? Just happen to be people.
And we don't... I don't like that too much.
It's Imagine plus, sneak attacking your door hit. Dasher.
Don't worry.
It's kind of... Well, we didn't dash it. That's the thing. It's like, it's not our fault. All right, so it's...
Good news. You don't have to worry about that guy too much anymore.
Right. Yeah, this particular problem is kind of solved.
So what are you
and
doing
I have pack
again?
Tactics, so I get advantage. Direwolf, then attack.
Got it.
And then so it's the d20 plus 5, and I don't have it on my sheet. I do apologize.
That's okay.
So that's 18.
Because of advantage, because of pack tactics.
Because of pack tactics, yeah.
Got it. That's fair. That'll hit.
That'll hit. Okay, then it's 2d6 plus 3. So 13.
Pack tactics.
Try to rip out that Achilles tendon.
So how much damage did he just take?
13.
Yeah, he's definitely feeling that. What's Chrysanthemum doing in the moment?
Chrysanthemum is a little bit confused and kind of like, okay, are we killing him or do we want to talk to him? She's not
if
sure.
If he surrenders, we won't kill him. How about
I
that?
I tried to talk to him. It didn't work.
How okay. you feeling now, buddy?
I'm
ready to surrender.
I'm gonna cast Thaumaturgy to make my voice loud, and I'm gonna stomp my little foot and yell, "Stop fighting and put your hands up!" Try and intimidate.
All right, roll the intimidation.
Hopefully the halfling's scarier than I am.
Got a big voice.
It's true.
It's not impossible.
Oh, it's still rolling. I'm waiting with bated breath.
Still rolling.
I see what it is. I know what it is. Is it still going?
There we go. Oh, wow.
Whoa! A nice critical. 20.
That's the power of thaumaturgy. That's the power of God.
I'm pretty sure I got a nat 20 the last time I used thaumaturgy on my voice, too.
That's the teacher voice.
Yeah, like seriously.
Voice. That's the teacher. Yes, the teacher voice with the accompanying glare.
Yep, that's exactly what's happening right now. This is trying to get him to surrender before anything worse happens.
All right. He'll... Yeah, he will take a step back from everybody and kind of, he kind of flips the blade so it's down. He's like, all right, we'll talk.
Thank you.
Back up your pooch.
I'm going to let go of his leg and just back up, like, you know, and do that growl. Like, I'm totally still going to eat your leg.
Licking your bloody chops.
Right. Delicious human flesh.
Is he completely out of the door?
He's standing like up against the wagon.
Yeah, he walked out.
He walked out to the wagon.
Threw me against the wall.
Yep. He turned around and threw you against the wall, so he's up against the wagon, so Chrysanthemum is behind him.
I want to peek in the door.
Okay. As you lean in, you're immediately assailed with a fragrant scent of a butcher shop. The smell of blood.
Please tell me it's not humans.
Meat. It's hard to see. There's a few lamps that have been recently, hurricane lamps have been lit to light the room against, you know, amidst all the snow blocking up the windows. And the general darkness, you know, so you can see what you're doing. You don't see any bodies per se.
All right. I'm just going to slide around the corner into the room to let my eyes adjust and kind of listen to what's going on out there, but watch for anybody who might be approaching from interior.
A very reasonable action, I would say. It's up there. Bink. All right. So turn that off. Whoop. Get us back to that. Because we're out of combat now. What do you want to know?
You want to take point, Arwen? I can if you don't want
to. Go for it. I'm not that great with the talking.
So I'll say.
I'm dramatic. I don't converse well.
Say first and foremost, how many more are inside?
What do you mean more?
People. Is it just you?
I don't know. Probably a good couple dozen squatters in there. I let them be in the tower part, away from my work.
And what exactly is your work?
Prepping meat.
Okay. Is this meat people?
Depends how you define your terms.
Jumir's eyes narrow. Okay. Who are you working for?
It's complicated. But don't ask questions. Show up. Bag of a body. Bag of money. Come back an hour later. Bag of meat.
Bit of a cleaner then.
Sure.
Do you know where the meat comes from?
Don't ask questions. Don't gotta know.
I say keep an eye on him, and I go to inspect the bag that he brought out and declared that it was a worthless hunk of junk or something to that effect, to return it to the Temple of Gond.
It may at one time have been a nimblewright.
I pick through it and see if I can find any vital components. I don't know exactly how nimblewrights function.
I just want to grab the whole bag.
But if there's a brain to recover or otherwise, and then also on the lookout for our MacGuffin, which I don't actually remember what it looks like.
You actually haven't yet seen the fabled Stone of Gollor.
Yeah, I don't think any of us know what it looks like.
So it's probably a stone of some kind. I would hope so. Otherwise,
maybe, unless that's like a, it's just like a code word. It's like really... piece of wood.
Yeah, that'd be. But am I able to find within the wreckage, unfortunately, any sort of stone?
Not among the nimblewright.
Say, did anything else come in with this one? A stone, maybe?
Maybe.
Can I make an insight check?
Oh, something came in with it.
Okay.
I'll give you that one for free. Tell you what.
I'm going to growl menacingly.
I'll let you know where the last set of meat left for. Y'all just bugger all off. We call it done.
Is that where the stone went?
Can't say. But y'all bugger off. Leave me alone. I'll tell you where my last outgoing shipment went.
I make an insight check to see if he's just trying to get out of, like, telling us and getting in trouble, but is trying to tell us.
Go for it.
You know?
Sure.
Right.
tell you, but I don't want to tell you, but I'm going to tell you anyway.
You didn't hear it from me, but...
You're right.
Like, because we wouldn't, you know, if it got back that he'd set it out, that'd be no good.
Yeah, that's exactly, I mean, yeah, this is, you didn't hear it from me, but...
I want to search in the room and see if there's, like, piles of, like, I don't know, like, clothing, belongings, odds and ends.
Yeah, you can, as you take a look around, and as you, for the most part, there's not a lot of stuff. As you start to rifle around, you look over, and in the doorway, there's a diminutive creature kind of, like, staring back out at you.
Oh.
And, like, hello. These big eyes, and the door kind of creeps open a little bit, and this little girl's head kind of pokes around. And she's wearing this felt hat that is easily way too big for her.
Oh, no. Hello. Who are you?
And she kind of looks at you. And she looks around the room. No.
No. Do I have any... get out, like, a little bit of, like, whatever. Do I have any food with me? We're traveling, yeah?
Oh, yeah, you have rations on you.
Fine. Yeah, I'll get some bread. Be like, are you hungry? Get it out and kind of offer it to her.
Yeah. She'll kind of reach out and take it. And as she comes out, you can see she's wearing, like, her jacket is a really high-end, well-crafted leather jacket with a fur lining on it that's, again, probably either built for a large halfling or a small human. And as she takes the food, so you can see there's, like, a slice in it that's been stitched over very badly on the big brown stain.
Are you here by yourself?
Mommy sleeping.
Have you seen a pretty stone?
Mm-mm. We take anything he doesn't take, and he doesn't take anything.
But no stones.
Mm-hmm. No stones.
Do you live here? Nom,
nom.
Mm-hmm. Well.
And then she kind of looks around and she, bye. And she scurries off again. As she goes, you notice the cloak on her back also has a massive blood stain on it.
Yeah. Yeah. Cast offs. Okay. Lovely. And I don't see anything of interest. If I just kind of search around, I don't find any stones or anything interesting lying around.
No, it's not. It's not. It's not lying out where you can see it.
Anything I should, like, drawers, chests, loose floorboards?
A good search will reveal in the time you have that it's a butcher shop. Now, the one thing you don't notice are any kind of, like, ways to, like, pin down the meat as it's being butchered. So on the upside, they're dead when they get cut up. Meanwhile,
yes, that's better than could be.
Meanwhile, outside, he does tell you, he gives you directions to a bakery that received the last shipment of meat.
Okay, it isn't the bakery that we've been to previously, is it?
It is not. There's more than one bakery in Waterdeep.
I mean, kind coincidences happen all the time.
Yeah.
But, Drewmere will sheath his blade and say, well, that deal works for me. Looks to Chrysanthemum.
Right. So I'm going to go back to work.
What'd you say your name was?
I didn't.
And then he starts to slide back out the door. Behind him.
He like steps aside and he got there's like a half bow as you let yourself out. Good meeting you. Hope I never see you again. Bam.
Well, technically speaking, we didn't meet him.
I mean, we met him, but he didn't introduce himself. I have a feeling he's gonna be able to handle, and I point at the dead body. I said, I have a feeling he's gonna be able to handle that. Let's just see if he had any money on him and make our way, shall we?
Sounds good to me.
Looking to Lorelei, I say, we good on the inside?
Yeah, nothing much. Some squatters. No obvious items of interest.
Which tracks out. You have a chance. The directions take you to a shop.
Did the dude have any money on him?
Okay, can I do a quick pause? Key, sure. I appreciate the troll, but I'm really sorry, my friend. That was like grade A fail on it. So thanks for coming by. We'll see y'all next time.
Oh, yeah. The internet.
I almost didn't want to ban him because I'm like I want to see what they did next.
Where is this going? How far can we get this to go?
That was so funny.
I mean, with writing talent like that, why not just create your own work?
Imagine misspelling a troll. A? You got three here tonight. Oh, it does not take much to amuse us. It really doesn't take much at all.
You want to be part of the show.
Oh, well, now he was. And we have been trolled. Mm-hmm. It means, folks, we have arrived.
We have but yeah, he did mention that he gets paid and does not ask any questions. So on the portion of getting paid, perhaps the money.
Yeah. What are you doing with the wagon that's there? It's got a bag of meat and a bag of a skull of a nimblewright.
Yeah. Probably.
The horse half kind of looks at all of you like, fuck you want me to do now?
If there's no payment on him or in the cart, I'll we could probably deliver the nimblewright head, but otherwise I'm gonna leave this man to his business.
Well, why don't we take the delivery cart to the bakery and someone be the delivery man?
I'm thinking the same thing because the horse knows the way.
You know what? So that's a great idea. Okay. Well, you're the one most shaped like this man at the current time. So once we see if we can get you in his cloak and then see if we can't pass you off as him.
Yeah. Well, I don't think I need to be him. I just need to be, I'll be the replacement.
Right.
So just I'll get his, some his scruffy clothes on so I look scruffy and kind of the same.
We'll just crawl into the back of the wagon and lie flat since I'm still a giant wolf.
Yeah, you guys can all like hop a ride, hide under the giant bags of not pre-used bags, other clean bags ish.
Sounds like a good plan.
Sure. Not hard to do. You get the cloak on, get the hood set, leave the body, the door opens to the windmill. You see kind of his hand come out, drag the body in.
Yep.
Door closes.
The bag he was carrying has been loaded in the cart, yeah?
Sure.
All right. Disgusting. Let's go.
Are we taking the bag with the nimblewright, putting it in the back too?
Yeah, I figure we can deliver it back to the Temple of God.
Sounds good.
Find the opportunity.
Okay. You make your way back into town. Curiously, the horse doesn't really know where you want it to go. So if you're going to let the horse lead it, It is either it's going to a part of town it's not familiar with, or it's not that familiar with the routes that it just walks the same route all the time.
All right. Do we want to go to the temple first or the bakery first?
I want to get rid of this meat as fast as possible. I don't want to be near this stuff at all, to be honest with you. Right. I mean, okay, so in my animal form, can I like roll to sniff like what kind of creature meat it is?
I was wondering about that with your scent.
Do you want to know?
And you avoid finding out.
Well, no, it's like the Disney princess part of her mind is like, no, I don't want to know. But like the inquisitive knowledge seeking part of her mind is like, I got to know. I got to know if they're eating people. Why would they be eating people?
Sure. Roll.
That'd
be a survival check.
Survival? What do they get? They get. I don't know.
When the problem comes along, advantage you must sniff it. Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah. With advantage. Wisdom
check. So let's go. Yeah. Let's just roll.
Yeah. That enhanced scent for a dire for wolf. Like, stiff it. Good. See, this is where we need that guy back. Meat of uncertain providence. Let's see here.
Wow.
Wow. That was a dedicated 13. you definitely pick up the scent of, that would be half elf and halfling. And human with a touch of fear.
Yeah, just gonna whine about that because I can't speak English about it right now. So,
Drumy will pat your head a little bit, not thinking too much about the complications of that.
So it's the bakery or the temple? You said the bakery is where you're headed.
Bakery, yes.
All right. It's not long before you find yourselves, what particular area are we going to now? The alley is in, it doesn't tell me which part of town it's in. It's in another part of town. Cause that's useful.
Let's say the docks because all the shady shit happens there.
Trades ward. There we go.
Oh, there you go.
Man, that was work. And indeed there you eventually come up along the thoroughfare. It's about It's coming up to closing time for most shops to a wonderful little, like storefront. It has like this, you know, big windows with all these baked goods lining it. And as you get closer, you notice they're all different pies.
Gross. Is there a way to go around back?
Yes. Actually, as you kind of go past the window, you can see this bright colors over the awning that advertises it as... Where did it go? I was literally just there is Cuddles meat pie.
Gross. All right. So Drumir, while I'm talking, you want to sneak in?
Sounds like a plan.
Yeah. You take the carriage around the back. There's an alley that goes up behind it and there's a back door to the place.
Great.
And very neat, crisp, hand painted lettering. It reads deliveries. Please knock politely if able.
I will knock politely.
Okay.
Is it a performance check to knock politely or
a relatively well fed woman answers the door. And she's got a little her hair is up under a handkerchief and she's rubbing her hands and cleaning them off of flour. Can I help you?
I have a delivery here.
Oh, no, that can't be right. We received a delivery an hour and a half ago.
Well, the regular guy, he got sick, so I got this job, and I don't want to mess it up. So you got to take this delivery. But told me to bring it here.
Are you sure? I've already had the delivery today.
I don't know. That scaly dude, he told me to bring it here.
Scaly
Must
dude?
Be for you. Yeah.
Oh, is he new? I didn't.
You know, in the windmill. The guy in the windmill.
The where? I'm sorry. Are you certain you're with the Butcher's Guild? I only take deliveries from the Butcher's Guild. I wouldn't dare take a delivery from anyone but the Butcher's Guild. Those men know how to use knives, you know.
But hey, I can smell the fear from here. Smell it over the dead bodies.
He had a cleaver. I don't know. This is above my pay grade. He told me to bring it here.
Well, I've already paid for one delivery today. You'll have to tell the guild I can't pay for two deliveries in one day. I mean, meat is hard to come by, but I...
Well, here, just come with me. Look and see what we've got and you know, check the if it's what you were supposed to receive. Maybe your previous delivery was short. I'm going to try to, like, draw her toward the wagon to clear the doorway.
Halfway out the door with you. She hasn't put up much of a fight, but...
Geez. I'm going to attempt to slide into the door.
We'll slide to the left. You quickly slip around behind her. The dire wolf is still in the back of the wagon. Where did you leave the halfling?
I'm hiding in the wagon. Okay. I'm hiding in the wagon.
Okay.
Yeah, like,
I'm gonna assume we put them.
I walked away to pee and then came back and they were gone. I'm
assuming we put the sack of meat at the back of the wagon.
There's a halfling standing outside of town next to a windmill going,
"What the heck, guys?
Well,
yeah, where'd they go?
Not again." No, I'm in the wagon.
Anyway. She starts to kind of look over the meats, and she's adamant that she's happy to take more, given that the prices are what they are, and she thought she'd already paid for what she'd received, but she really has no money to give you for the meat, and she really doesn't want to take it unless you're really confident she's not supposed to pay for it.
Well, you might need to pay for it later, but it's here now. We don't want it to go bad.
True.
How about I carry it in for you?
Meanwhile, as Dremir has a chance to look around, it is a perfectly unexciting storeroom. There's bags of flour, various bags of sugar, all neatly crated. Everything in that beautiful handwritten stencil, writing on everything is labeled perfectly. The shelves are labeled for what the boxes are, and the boxes are labeled on their shelves.
So I'm in some sort of back room.
Yes.
Storage.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it says like flour, and then there are like little wood crates that says flour, and inside there are sacks on which has been written flour.
Flour.
Yeah. Everything has a place.
Well, knowing that the woman might return shortly, I'm going to see if there's a way out of this room. I'm looking to go more so into like a back office, more so than like the front.
Okay.
To see what's about.
On the rodeo, you guys are all standing right about here. There's your wagon. Actually, I'll draw your wagon on real quick.
Wait, where?
One of the links that was disabled blending was Albert Rodeo.
So there's your wagon, and there's the horse. There we go. And if you pay attention to such things, Drumir is boink right there.
Ah, a fantastic token too. Okay. It, it's pretty neat.
Yeah, that's pretty nifty.
I'm going to see if I can't peek or open the door a crack and peek inside to see if I can get an idea of what's on the other side.
Sure. As you open the door and peek through, you quickly notice that you are looking in on an actual kitchen.
Hmm. Okay. Does it appear to be empty of persons?
At the present, it is.
All right, then I am going to quickly move into that room and close the door quietly behind me.
So you're going into the kitchen and closing the door behind you?
Yep.
No problem. You are 100% inside the kitchen.
Cool. Looking around, I suspect this would be not the place to keep such an important artifact. And so I'm going to move to the next area and see if I can do the same there. Conscious of not exactly knowing Lorelei's, is it Lorelei or Lorelei?
Lorelei.
Lorelei, sorry. Lorelei's stalling capabilities. I'm going to attempt to make haste.
Through the next door?
Yes, please.
Give me 10 gonna peek first, though. Seconds. Dump. Bink. And bink. And bunk. There we go. All right. Meanwhile, let's see here. Grab my eraser. Bink. And what you're looking out into that is the storefront proper. So racks of pies. There's a counter. There's a small cash box. That's probably locked, if you had to guess.
Probably.
There's a side door, and then the main entrance is off the map.
And it's presently unoccupied?
Unoccupied.
Okay. How close is that cash box?
Well, it depends. How badly do you want to steal from a baker?
I mean, it seems like a nice bakery. Maybe they've got a couple coin.
Oh, you can all, yeah, you're within reach of the cash box.
Yeah, I'm going to see if I can't pick it in one attempt.
Okay.
You acquire some wealth. I mean, this is
what
you got your degree for.
Yeah.
Listen, if I don't steal as I go, I'll never come back.
You just keep telling yourself what you have to, man. Just keep telling yourself.
If I don't get it now, I won't be able to get it later.
Right.
And I mean, she's clearly dealing with illicit goods. Like, I'm not in the wrong here. Not that it's particularly
important. Is she?
I mean,
is she?
Or the guy gave us.
She certainly hasn't done her research.
Okay.
Sources aren't sustainable. Aren't ethically sourced.
Well, they're sustainable. They're not ethically sourced.
Yeah. Two different things.
And maybe they're ethically sourced. We need to get to the bottom of this so we can find out.
Mm-hmm.
I give it the old college try. Got a 13.
13's enough to pop the lock on this thing. It's a little lock box in a bakery in the trades ward. It's not exactly known for its high security.
I mean, you know. But yeah, what? How much coin do I spy inside?
You could probably pick up about 20 silver.
With that few, I'm going to say, all right, she probably... It's probably not worth the risk of her noticing. I will close and relock it if I am able. And then continue on through the next door with our peak strategy.
Yeah. As you continue to explore, I'll give you this, and this will be the last one. We'll switch back.
Sure.
Because this one actually kind of caps off the interesting... You're looking out on an alleyway. It continues around the corner. So there, this does go around the corner here, and there's a door here.
Right. And the door, it appears to be a separate room attached to this building. Is it labeled, or does it seem to be?
It is not labeled with any kind of signage.
Okay. Well, I may have failed to make a perception check while I was in the storage room to see if I spied any particular important objects. But we'll just assume that, you know, it's not here. It might be in this new room. But I imagine I would have spotted it if it was sitting next to the lockbox. It wasn't in the lockbox, so... It's either in the storage room or somewhere else.
Okay. As you're looking down there, you do notice a figure standing against the door, kind of just wrapped up against the wind. he looks up kind of in your direction as you open the door and pop your head out.
Does it look like he sees me?
I don't know. Roll me a quick stealth check. He's trying to kind of monitor the area. So
I'm not freeze his face.
He's going to be looking for something.
Oh, wonderful.
Let's
two.
See. This
for nine.
Is... Which of the two is this? It's that one. So
is that a reroll? Do you guys think? Get two of them.
Okay, Boink will put that right there.
I'm okay with that.
Yeah, go for it.
All right, I'm going to attempt to reroll that, as being spotted right now would be no good.
Okay.
Okay, that's marginally better. 13.
A 13. Okay. Doesn't look like he's seen you.
I will pop my head back in and quickly try to make my way out the front entrance, as
and then
it were.
Loop around to join the party?
Something like that, yeah.
Meanwhile, Lorelai is talking up the baker, and she's willing to take the meat as long as you make it absolutely clear this was part of the previous shipment, because she cannot pay for another shipment, and she does not want to be indebted to the Butcher's Guild.
Absolutely.
Oh, yeah. Once you come around to, like, telling her, like, oh, no, you're not paying.
Free meat.
For sure you're not paying for this. She's, like, on board with taking it.
Absolutely. Let me help you carry it in.
Oh,
pick it up.
Thank you.
Put it over my shoulder. Come on, Nala.
I'll just follow like a trained dog. 100%. Yeah, no, I'm totally playing along with this one.
She's mildly fazed by the dire wolf bringing things in. There's definitely a certain amount of like, wait, what?
Yeah, you can just throw it
on
my back.
That's okay. Just move quick before she has time to think about it. I just want to get the dire
wolf exactly.
inside so he
this
can
This is the normal
around.
Thing to do.
Good call.
We've seen rangers before. It's not the weirdest thing, right?
I mean, it is a wolf the size of a person.
Who's going to argue with him?
You know,
true.
You bring up a good point.
Okay, well, let's use that token as our baker for all intents and purposes.
I wonder what
Where would you like it?
On their,
oh, you could
check.
Just you could just set it in there. I'll take care of sorting it out by the various cuts.
Oh yeah, they're large. That's a horse-sized wolf.
Yeah.
Am I visible? Like. They're getting stuff out of the wagon. Am I out in the open?
You tell me.
I imagine we would be conscious enough to pull the actual meat and avoid the actual.
Yeah. I'm going to stay hidden as long as she's still right there. But if she goes into the storage building, I might want to get out and just like take a peek around the surroundings.
Okay.
But I don't want to get out if she's going to see me get out of the wagon.
Yeah, she'll go in and kind of help put the meat where, you know, kind of set the bag down. She's, I really do need to sort it myself, but thank you for bringing it in. You're so sweet. Nothing like my neighbors.
I just want to do a good job. Just so glad to have this job that, you know, I just want to make sure that you're satisfied and this is where you need it and everything is fine.
I'm just going to whine incessantly and just nose up to the butcher, just like, or nose up to the lady, just as if I want something from her. And I know that she knows what it is, but she clearly doesn't know what it is because.
What did she say?
How could she possibly know what it is?
I'm so sorry. I don't know what's happening. This is very strange behavior.
And she like looks around for like a spare piece of meat to give to you. She puts it down on the ground and kind of pushes herself back up against one of the supply racks to give you as much room as she can.
It very slowly and just like I'm inspecting it because I'm just wasting as much time as possible.
So where's Arwen off and exploring?
I'm just going to get out of the wagon and I'm not going to like go anywhere. I'm just going to like take a walk around this back alley, just kind of looking around. Are there windows I can peek through? Anything of note? In that back area without going in anywhere.
The areas that are like still clouded over are just kind of like, you can see into this one near you. You can't see down this alley without starting down it.
Okay.
I'll go ahead and pop the fog off this one. It's just there. There's nothing in that.
Okay. How about that backside of that building? Are there like windows I could peek through?
No, there are not. So all along here is just wall.
Okay. I'll start moving toward that little alleyway. Just, again, just curious. Not looking for anything in particular, just kind of taking stock of the surroundings.
Okay. You kind of creep your way around over there. And about now, Dramir is going to come sneaking back up the alley here.
And the cameras fit on the alleyway, and you go around the corner, the camera pans to the right, and I come around the corner.
Yep.
Where is everybody?
They're inside unloading the stock.
Mm-hmm. Get you where you can see each other then.
The meat that she gave me, people.
Yeah.
I'm not going to eat it.
She seems
I'm going to whine.
The knowledge of what human tastes like is probably not a great idea.
Well, because it's one of those things where it's like, as a scientist, she's probably like, oh, but like, it would be really good to know, but also like, no.
All right, well.
Science, but ew.
Right, exactly. Science, but
there, there are ethical limits to most science.
But this one could turn into animals, so I'm like partially like, but...
You'd know.
No,
you would know too well how human tastes.
Ew.
And that's why I'm sniffing it so hardcore. I'm trying to really like racking my head with this moral dilemma here.
All right. Well, thank you so much. Have a wonderful evening.
He's like, okay. And remember, I didn't pay. This was paid for.
Of course.
I am paid in full with the Butcher's Guild.
Yes, indeed.
Okay, I can
have a lovely evening.
I can do that. As your have Arwen, give me a perception check, and Dramir.
Perception.
The two in the building are not going to have a chance to see this as they come out. However, it's a 22.
Critical.
Nice. As you do, you see a figure vault from this corner of the building across to this corner at the top of this building and kind of disappear over the
lip of the roof.
Disappear over the lip of the roof. It's in that moment that you hear a shout from the alley right next to Chrysanthemum as someone goes, "There she is! Get him!"
This seems relevant to our interests. I would recommend we get close.
Yes, I would recommend that as well. However, it should be noted that as that shout comes, out of that dark alley rush 5 bugbears.
Oh.
Out of which dark alley? Sorry.
Un.
Oh.
De. Trois. Ca. Cinq.
Rushing at the chrysanthemum or toward the alley?
They're rushing out of this alley.
Is this like a dumpster or something in the corner of the butcher shop and that dark roof onto which they vaulted?
A dumpster.
See that
thing?
Crates.
Crates. I wish to climb the crates and vault onto the roof.
Okay, you can start heading that direction. Actually, that would be... You're going to start heading towards the roof. There's a figure disappeared on the roof. A type of hobgoblin comparable to the boogeyman. Yeah. More like the hobgoblin side. As they come charging out and Lorelei is looking for a way to climb up, they're going to take this opportunity to... Well, three are heading this way, and two are going to stop and play with Chrysanthemum.
Oh, no.
Mm-mm. Unacceptable.
I'm going to yelp and use one of my dwarf swears.
so this is where we're going to refresh our beverages.
Because this gonna get serious, is what this is gonna do.
It's about to get spicy.
This is gonna get serious, don't you know now?
I see.
So, I'm gonna giggle because I wasn't sure what you're talking about. Yes. In fact, let's see here. I can't just put a graphic up on the. You know what? We'll take a break. I'll give you some links when I get back. We'll see you back here in 4 minutes.
Thumbs up.
Oh, jeez.
Boy, that sucks. Like, I feel bad for him. Okay.
I've never seen this before.
Unspeakable brutality.
Yeah, a little closer. Go to the right. Oh no, I dropped down. Oh no, I'm under us.
I think they're sinking.
Yeah, they're so.
Okay, drop the anchor so we can collect our stuff. We're here. Thank you for coming in. My name is Rob, aka Lantern Noir. We are playing Dungeons and Dragons, an original game of crap.
I didn't know that was.
As you seem to be doing really well with it.
Ooh, that 20 is 25.
Oh my gosh. Nice. I scattered it.
Wow. Well, you can roll your damage.
I don't 25. Because I got 3 sixes.
Holy cow.
Oh my goodness. Why she's hulked out.
Rage hard.
Yeah, I think you should rage all the time. I think you should never not. Yeah, never not be raging.
Well, there's where all our good rolls were hiding.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, that's why they were so bad earlier. We were saving up. But...
Stop hitting my friends.
You're damaged books with that kind of attitude.
Well played. Wow. He goes in, he does a few loops, he comes back out, and beep.
Okay. Beep once if there's dead bodies in there. Beep twice. No, that doesn't work. All right, beep twice. No, that doesn't work. Okay, beep. Oh, screw it. I'm going to see if I can sneak up. See if I can sneak up and find a window to kind of like. It's not really the sharpest hack in this box.
Yes.
So we assume this guy is bad.
Oh, he's super bad.
Well, you know.
Okay. That's all I needed to know.
Good. I mean, he keeps on trying to. He's a dick. He keeps on trying to coerce Irina into coming up to his castle and fucking die, become a vampire lady. And she's not into it.
Well, I mean, you know, okay. For something.
So the final decision is you are actually going to load the were-rat into the wagon.
Apparently.
Yes. Let's sell
him. I mean.
Yeah.
Winning Baldur's Gate.
Not called the wide for nothing.
Tail. All right.
We'll eat his friends. We'll eat his little minions. Yeah. Like, when were-rat is a little, but like, the roasted, like, the rats that we have charred via
roast
ember.
Rat. I can produce flame. We can get this cooking. It's good.
Yeah, like, I'm telling you, rat charcuterie. Let's go.
Beat you, they get to win.
Okay. I can handle that. It's a 40-cent bet to me.
Bet $5.
Table max. All right. 80 cent raise. Oh, this is going to make
80 cents. 80 cents is for fools, young lady.
Oh, jeez.
All of it. I have, 480. Get out.
I can't wait to save these.
I have a king. Get out. Yes. You were wondering if I had a king? I have a king.
Out.
Get out.
Out. Oh, she's going to go in. She doesn't buy it. She doesn't buy it.
Because she has a 4.
You think?
I think she has an ace 4.
Yep.
So here's the deal.
She's in.
Some would say she's in.
Oh.
Does she have the other king?
Yes.
She has the other one?
Yep, but we have the 10. And we take that pot away from her.
Yep.
punch the... No, I know that's a bad idea.
There is so much nope surrounding this trap. I am not here for an amulet. I am here for a traumatized rogue. Let's get the fuck out of here. Oh, I'm sorry.
That's two.
Well, I wasn't really concerned about the amulet. I just thought that...
You're swinging again.
Oh, man. Oh, this guy is tough. What's up with this guy?
What?
This doesn't happen. This doesn't happen. All right. We're going. Let's go.
Okay.
And followed by the smite. Come on. Timber. We got this.
I mean, if he doesn't go down now, I don't know.
And he finally drops.
Yes.
And is out of the scrap. Gets to the guy in the
way. Way already.
Oh yeah! Welcome back, everybody. As we come out of our clips and into the game, and for those that are curious, yoink! Let me get you a nice view. That's a bugbear. And you know who else has a great idea of what bugbears look like? That girl right there. Because she's presently looking at two of them. That on their charge past her have decided that they're going to take her out on their way by.
Mistake.
Is it though?
Big mistake.
Is it?
Like, hey, it's food.
All right. Now we're getting serious.
Get up in there. Bugbear grills. Sure. Yeah, well, we could do that. I would love it if everybody involved in the combat could roll initiative.
Part I'm good at.
Not bad.
Eesh. Bummer.
Okay, so
That good at, apparently.
Lorelei comes in at 11. Jermir comes in at 17. Nala is taking stock of the moment and pacing herself.
Still concerned over whether she should eat this piece of meat or not.
still confused by the meat.
Right. It's a unique opportunity.
Okay. There we go. We'll switch out to the combat view so everyone can see the initiative tracker. We'll get on with it. That first bugbear that kind of came out of nowhere is going to do everything it can to take out the halfling.
Oh, no.
And let's see. It rolls an 11. I don't think that's going to hit.
That's not going to hit.
Glance over it. That is not going to hit your 18. Your shield comes up, it's like, here. It's a good thing you're not sneaky.
No, it's not. It is.
Yeah, because that shield is like the only thing between you and certain death right now.
And the armor. The armor's helping too.
Going to break him into a halfling? I don't know. What happens when you take half a halfling?
Quarterling, obviously.
We break her into a quarterling?
Yeah.
Speaking of halfling, how is she handling this moment?
Okay. Let's see. The one that took a swipe at me.
Yes.
Number three. We're gonna cast a Toll the Dead.
You are in melee range with him, though.
I am in melee range. That's true.
He might poke you.
I don't think I've used my melee attack yet.
Yeah, you do have a mace.
Oh, I also have spiritual weapon.
Oh, sorry, handy.
I got I got new things. I'm not sure what all what I haven't used all of them yet.
As a bonus action, you can. So that's what you can summon it. Yeah.
Okay, that's to summon.
Which one?
Bonus action.
Spiritual weapon.
Spiritual.
Yeah, weapon. You get to summon it and attack on the first one.
Mm-hmm. It's a bonus action to summon it or order it to attack. If I remember right.
Right, yeah. But you do get an attack off the first.
Off the first summon, yeah.
Yeah. It's a really good spell.
But again, you're casting while you're in combat.
Warcaster feat, right? That does something, maybe?
Oh, you took the Warcaster feat?
I did take Warcaster.
Oh.
Yeah. This edition doesn't really penalize you for casting in combat, though.
Oh, that's
It's more so maintaining.
That's true.
It's quite forgiving. But it then is. It took away flanking, and it took away a lot of the real benefit of grappling, which is fine.
Which is good.
Which is fine.
Okay, yeah. I was
the less grappling we can do, the better.
I was having addition collision in the head there. You can cast while you're up close.
Okay, well, I wasn't sure where you were going with that. I was like, what?
That's the third, five, and second, and first edition issue.
See, I've only played fifth, so... I was like, I don't, I sense you're steering me away, but I'm not sure why. I mean, I appreciate the help, but
no
I'm
problem.
Confused.
No problem. So what are you ultimately coming down on?
Caster Cleric really nice.
What?
What are you coming down on as a plan then?
I think we're going to go with Spiritual Weapon.
Nice.
Okay.
What does that look like?
What is her Spiritual Weapon?
See, I haven't had a chance to think about this yet.
Never mind. Cast it. What are you attacking with? Or who are you attacking with it?
I'm attacking the one that just attacked me.
Okay. Yoink. No problem. As you cast it, roll your attack roll with it. And that is your bonus. You still have a full action. A incredibly large wine bottle shimmers into existence behind him and swings at the back of his head. And he kind of like ducks under it for a second. And he like has this look of like, what? And then he looks at you and there's a moment where it's like, he's not sure if he's impressed or horrified. And Savage, we're glad to have you on the chat. Cheapskate, glad to have you here as well. We have an international cast again tonight, our audience tonight. Our cast is not international, but we are literally coast to coast. So we got that rocking on for us. And we're sorry, Savage, that you're missing D&D. You can enjoy it here with us tonight. You have an attack action, though, you can also take. I put the sword thingy out there as your wine bottle.
Okay. Can I make an attack with that, or was it just to...
That was
summon it?
Yep. Your bonus action to attack with it made its attack. It is now on the board, and you are now concentrating.
I am concentrating.
Actually, I don't think spiritual weapon is concentration.
I'm pretty sure.
It's not. It doesn't have the...
It's a very good spell.
It is a very good spell.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll be dang.
I did not know that.
Yeah, we have a confirmation from chat. It does not require concentration.
It is a very good spell.
Spiritual Guardians. That's when it's concentration, because that sucker is like freaking OP clutch.
It is AOE.
It is nice. So what are you doing with your main action?
My main action, I am going to, I'm going to make an attack with my mace and just kind of like.
Kneecap number 3?
Yep.
Go for it.
You're having a bad day.
Let's see, a 13 is not going to hit it.
Okay.
As it brings its club down on top of your hammer and kind of like pushes you away. You kind of pull your mace back with yourself as you stumble in the snow.
Okay, fair enough.
Day is not that bad yet.
He is unimpressed.
We'll have to change
that. Very unimpressed. How's Drumir doing?
Drumir is alarmed by the sudden explosion of... bugbears, and is going to attempt to close the distance. Using his cunning action, he is going to dash, which gives me 60 feet of movement because I took skulk or what is it, spry, something like that.
Okay, but you can get just about anywhere you want to get.
Yeah. So I can't. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, whatever. I'm gonna go right here. Say, hey, get away from here. Stand back. We'll pull out my short sword. As I am running, the blade starts to cackle with a green candescence to it. And I cast Green Flame Blade.
Green Flame Blade.
Yeah.
Handy little cantrip that.
That's a very nice spell.
Where's my character sheet?
It's so snazzy.
It's very fancy.
Very snazzy. All right, make the attack mm-hmm. roll now. You've got it going. I remember I almost put this on my my NPC in Ravenloft.
I guess I just make a regular attack.
Yeah, just make your attack roll.
On which one?
On the
battle hit. Looks like he's at number 4.
Yes,
number 4. I meant which character we're going to put it on for Raven.
Oh, Arabelle.
Oh.
I don't see her using a sword anytime.
That's the thing. That's part why she didn't. I was like, eh.
Okay.
Okay, so yeah, that'll totally hit. Roll damage.
Yep.
As you lay into him. Don't forget your sneak attack, because Arwen is threatening him.
I am sure to not. So I do...
Jeez, I hate you sometimes.
16 points of slashing damage. And then as part of the green flame, As the action, there's a flick at the end of it, and fire leaps from the blade to the adjacent bugbear.
Three or five? 2
damage.
Hmm? The one that is currently attacking her, or the one that's still standing back figuring out what to do?
Number 3, please.
Number 3. The flame leaps over to him, so he's... Let's recap his life so far. The boss said, go get him! He sees this halfling standing there. He turns around, goes to flatten her, gets nearly hit with a spiritual wine bottle, nearly kneecapped by her when she counterattacks, and now has a bit of green flame leap off his buddy and onto him.
Yep, for 2 points of fire damage.
I think it's more the principle that I wanted to recap there. Like, let's just recap how this guy's day is going, all right?
It's not going great.
He did not plan for most of this when he woke up this morning. This was supposed to be an easy job, and it's just gotten a little too interesting.
It was supposed to be a milk run.
It's like going into Wisconsin. You go in, you go back out again.
I do not squish that easily.
Okay. This one turns around and says, okay, now it's mad at this other thing that showed up. So it's going to crush it instead.
Oh, no.
And it redirects its attention from Chrysanthemum to Dremir and just... wham! And Dremir has to like take multiple steps back and actually like slot, you know, kind of half falls down in the snow, taking 9 damage.
Yikes.
And is not feeling this.
Yep. Glass cannon.
Number 2 is going to continue his run down the alleyway and out of sight. And number 1. Oh, what's Lorelei doing? Liz, talk to us.
I would like to. Can I use dash to get up onto the roof, or does that preclude climbing?
You have enough movement. As long as you make your checks, you can get up on the roof right now.
All right, that is what I would like to do. So athletic or acrobatics?
Technically athletics. Acrobatics would be like an interesting dive off the roof. But you still have to physically pull yourself up.
Okay.
What if you're like in the Batman cartoon?
Oh, for God's sake. I fail miserably.
Yes, you did. It's just not a lot of good handholds there. Unfortunately.
All right, then.
You can.
I guess I'll have to. That was my bonus action.
No, you still have, that would have been your move action.
That would have been my move. Okay.
So you still could, you can still make an attack from there if you want to chuck a knife at something. You could also theoretically use your cunning action to get a dash, which gives you another move and just charge in the melee, or you can take another attempt to get up there. Rogues are pretty nimble.
All right.
I'll let you use your cool roguey abilities to get up there.
Okay. And what would I use then?
Let's roll athletics again.
My athletics is bad. My acrobatics is good.
Yeah, you do great cartwheels, but climbing walls is a kind of a different skill set.
I mean, but what about hardcore parkour? We'll try again.
All right. So I got a 13.
Okay.
How hard, I don't know how hard it is to climb the side of a building, so.
Let's see here. Label. Rooftop. Okay. You are now on the rooftop.
Great. All right. And then can I attack?
What are you attacking?
The bugbear number.
Oh, no. Silly question. You've already used all your time to get up. You used your action to get up there.
Okay. That took all my time. Okay.
That's you. You spent all of your time then. Climbing to the rooftop.
Great.
I'm going to put you right there on the edge of the roof.
Okay.
That was probably not a bad use of your time, though, because it does give you a pretty good position.
Nice vantage point. Potentially be able to hide around the lip of it and see where that
Do
this
I
individual...
see who went running across the top of the roof when I get up there?
No, you don't from here.
Okay.
Doesn't help any that the snow is starting to kick up too. Visibility is a little dodgy. And the roof is pitched and slick.
Oh, goody.
Now, I'd like to remind you, you chose to go on the roof.
That's okay, because that will be a dex check, and I feel a little bit more confident in that.
That makes sense. Number five, he actually has a feeling this is not going great. So he is going to step. What's he doing? He's going to any reindeer up there? Maybe. He's going to come over here and attack Tremere. Obviously, you're a threat. He's going to squish you like a bug. He does squish you like a bug.
For eight. I'm bug sized.
Yes, for another eight. Oof. As Tremere is now being double teamed. See, where is that guy there to pick up on this joke? See, this is what happens. You miss all the fun stuff when you're trolling us. So Nala, who is currently a dire wolf, does what?
I would like to also join the dog pile. I'm just gonna run in and into that corner space and jump in on four. See if I can't take him off his feet.
Doink. I want to leave them visible, so I'll do this. There we go. That's a nice view. That's right, you have to custom your rolls.
I know, I'm sorry.
13 plus?
It's plus 5.
Plus so 5 is going to hit.
Or that plus 5. We can either or.
Yay, pack tactics.
And then that's 11 damage, and then he has to make a strength save, DC 13, or get knocked prone.
He could just die.
Or he could just die.
He could just die.
That's acceptable.
He would still be prone, probably.
He would still be prone.
Whipped to the ground hard and just does not get up.
Yeah.
The desired effect was achieved.
Mm-hmm. Yep, he's out. He explodes into a prone position. Unrelenting prone. Yes, so that went well.
Permanently prone.
Permanently prone. Number three is up. He's the one that initially attacks Chrysanthemum and somehow summoned this wacky, crazy bottle. And he's going to do what he can to squish her. He's not having any of this. He connects.
Oh.
For 50. Okay. He connects for 15.
Okay.
Here's the good news. You don't have to make a concentration check.
I do not.
You do not. You're not concentrating right now.
I'm not concentrating.
You're not concentrating.
And I would have advantage even if I did.
Exactly. So how do you respond?
Ouch. I'm still a bit above half, so I'm going to stay on the offensive. So to attack with my spiritual weapon is a to attack is a bonus action.
It's a bonus action. Okay. Yep.
So then I'm going to make an attack. I'm going to make a melee attack with my mace.
Okay. Ooh.
That's not going to hit.
Whiff. Yeah, he's unfazed by that.
I'm a little distracted.
No hit. There's actually, you like start to take a swing and you feel this paw on your forehead as he just slides you back on the snow and your mace just goes right through that opening gap.
Oh, that's just
wait.
Mad.
Ari's got your back. She wants you to re-roll that.
Oh, thank you, Ari. All right, let's try that again. That's better.
That's much better.
It's much better. However. It's not better enough.
Not better enough. Okay.
Yes.
Not quite as embarrassing, though. Okay, and then I'm going
to
use my...
Techie's back and kicking in some advice, too. Your bonus action to kick off the other thing?
Yeah, bonus action for the bottle of wine.
Hit it.
I'm imagining that the label of the wine bottle has Timora's symbol on it.
Yes. It absolutely does.
And it comes like, wham, right down on them. You can roll your damage from that.
Nice.
Okay. Okay, so why isn't it letting me roll my damage?
He's checking.
There we go.
Okay, so do we have a bug? Please don't have a bug. 8. That'll clean his clock a bit. As it smashes and just, you know, spiritual wine cascades everywhere. And then as the bottle, as it comes, follows through, as it comes back up again, there's a full bottle.
Nice.
And it's like right back at it.
I refuse to be squished.
Yeah. You were just distracting him so that you could hit him with a spiritual weapon.
Pretty much. Right. That's the plan.
Right. That was always the plan, right?
That was always the plan.
Yeah. Jermier, what's going on?
Drumir is going to.
How's our other rogue doing?
Going to feel relatively bloodied. Is going to use his roguish action to disengage, take a couple steps back, drawing out his longbow, short bow. He's short.
Okay.
He needs a short bow. And is going to take a shot at. Let's do this. Let's ready a shot at number 5 for when he comes into melee range of any of my allies, because then I can get sneak attack. Or I could just shoot number 3. I'm going to shoot number 3. Okay. That's effectively the same thing, but just lot simpler.
Okay, from a tactical point of view, as long as the DM doesn't decide you're more scary than the other guys, you'll get your sneak attack damage for sure against 5.
Right.
But Nala won't get her pack damage, her pack advantage, if she gets there first.
Right. If she, wait.
If she has to move to 5.
Right.
Just
well, she's going to have
to
move to 5 to 3, so.
Yep.
Okay. Why don't we.
It gets its turn before me, though, so unless 5 is
running
away.
Never mind.
He'll
that was all really good advice until yes, someone looks at the tracker and figure out who goes when.
Yeah, I was
what
like,
you
I'm
doing?
Pretty sure they're going to come to me.
What are you going to do?
Preferably
ignoring me.
I'm going to ready a shot.
Okay, so you're going into readied mode.
Yep.
Sounds good.
Also, I looked it up, and Timora's favorite weapon is the spinning coin, which is a shuriken. At least in third edition,
ooh,
it was.
Ooh, interesting.
That's good to know. Yeah. Break that down.
I like the wild bottle of wine though.
I like exploding and reforming bottles.
Oh my gosh!
As well.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. 2 is gonna is you can hear fighting from around the corner. We're not really sure what's going on over there, but there's fighting coming from the other side of this small building.
I'm just upset that we were
we were caught in the crossfire here. We were just here minding our own business, delivering, you know, questionable meat. And here we have bugbears attacking us. This city, it used to be so safe. You know, I have a word.
Man, this place has gone downhill.
This place has really gone downhill. You know,
I can't even deliver dead bodies. I mean,
in broad daylight.
I'm kind of amazed no one told the lady at the bakery what she was buying. Either you guys are cruel or you're kind. I'm not sure which it is.
I think she doesn't know.
I was just going to figure she knew already. If she's been buying from them regularly.
Drumir's not going to be the one to tell her.
Well, we'll talk in a second about that. Those who have been in Waterdeep a few bits will have a moment to realize what just happened. Okay, so Lorelei slides along the rooftop. That's a lot of movement. Can I get a dex check, please?
Oh, sure.
Or a dex save? I'll give you the dex save.
Oh, wait, a save? I'm sorry.
Yeah, dex save, please. Again. Okay, you're still on your feet up there.
Oh, good. All right. So I would like to shoot. Sorry, I forgot what number. Number 5 with my short bow.
Okay, they can totally do that.
Oh, for heaven's sake.
That's going to miss.
And then do I still get a... sneak attack?
That would be bonus damage if he had been engaged with somebody. But you'd still have to hit.
Oh, right, he's not engaged. I got you.
Yep. He's not.
Okay.
Which still, I mean, it still checks out.
Talking to a couple people.
He's definitely
that's my useless move.
On the dating websites. Yeah, I mean, it's hard to take that next step. I get it.
I successfully did not fall off the roof. That's all I managed.
Did we spot the other roof and the roofed individual?
I think they're down the alley and we just haven't peeked around the corner yet.
Actually, you know what? Why don't you roll me a perception? Yeah, through the rain, through the slick and snow, Liz. Let's see if Lorelei picks up on something while she's up there. Maybe this is why she missed. No, okay. I will take that. Bink. I'll put her right on that rooftop.
Oh.
Nice.
And I'll label her so we remember that she's up on the rooftop. Vente arrow, but a Trenta bow.
Oh. And where's this bow pointing?
I'm going to take it up with Polymorph. Meanwhile, so there is someone up on the rooftop now that you can see. It's a little hard to make out. She's all kind of like wrapped up in black. Her cloak is kind of fluttering in the wind as it kicks up. And she's kind of like down in a crouch. And she's watching, clearly watching the fight below her. And every once in a while, I mean, you can glance at her. She pulls a knife from her sleeve and chucks it down below.
Hmm. Interesting.
Meanwhile, oh yes, because number one is currently fighting down there. That makes sense. Number 5. Okay, Alec, take your shot.
All right. Let us do just that. Actions, short bow. 9. Probably not.
Nope.
He lurched forward in a way I wasn't expecting. Unfortunate.
He moved a little weird. That's all that happened.
The bugbears, you know, they're a little weirder than you think.
Let's see. Given the choices, he's going to beat on the thing that he might actually take out. Sorry, Arvin.
The wine bottle?
Yeah, fair enough.
Oh. Do you guys have a plan for if Chrysanthemum goes down?
What are you asking for? No reason.
I was gambling on not casting a healing spell because I was still about half, but I'm starting to think that.
We do have healing potions.
It's only 10.
I have good berry suppositories.
But you are tanking for the entire party against a bunch of bugbears.
I mean, I took 2 hits.
I didn't. I'm not built for tanking.
None of us are.
I did not build Chrysanthemum.
We're built for subterfuge, not open warfare.
I'm just here to play tricks on people. Why am I getting hit?
It's when you summoned the giant bottle of wine. Everyone got really concerned. So,
so what's Nala doing in this moment?
Yes, I'm going to try to take five to the ground. Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know what better action there is for me right this second.
What was the resolution of that? Or were you just remarking that she has kind of less hit points than we thought?
Yeah, well, she's at six, so I mean,
yikes.
I mean, I could turn back into a person and drop a spell on top of her.
I'm in yikes range.
I am in yikes range. Yeah, I mean, if I take the guy off his feet, everyone gets a turn on him before his next turn. So let's try that.
Okay, who are you taking off their feet?
I'm gonna try to take five to the ground.
Okay, roll your attack. As you try and grab onto a leg and pull, you do get the advantage because there's a pack. Neither
that
one's
would be
going to get
16.
Neither one's 16. 16 will hit.
Sorry, it's plus five. It's 18.
Okay, 18 will hit.
My bad. All right.
So give me damage.
12, and then DC 13 strength check. I want to get this bugbear on his butt.
He stays on his feet though.
He's strong.
He's too strong for me.
They're tough. He's like, you start pulling at him. He's like, no.
They're growling at each other.
Yeah.
Let's see, which takes us around to three. Oh, Kenny? Does he? He does not.
Will he?
He does not.
Will he? Won't he?
He's pushing his advantage against Chrysanthemum and does not succeed in dropping her.
Nice.
Good. That's very good.
You okay, Liz?
Oh no!
I think we lost
Liz.
She
has become paralyzed with fear.
For a second, I'm like, "Wow, she's trying really hard to stay awake," and I'm like, "Nope, I think her camera's frozen."
She just froze.
She gone.
Okay, I want to text her.
It's a good picture for her. You know,
it's like
very intimidating. Like, oh, okay.
It's a nice hat too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, we lost a Liz.
Speak of the devil and she shall disappear.
We lost a Liz. All right, let me do this.
I think that's a phrase.
I will hold her spot until she gets
back.
Liz
casts invisibility.
Quick shifting of the Zoom call.
I went to a, whatchamacallit, a heavy metal concert up in Mechanicsburg, Pennsylvania last night. And one of the bands was a band called Spellbook. And their guitarist had this leather-like Inquisitor hat that I'm sure he got from a Renaissance festival. It was super cool. It was a great concert. But they were a couple of old-timers, as it were. And they could fucking shred. So, you know.
That's awesome. I miss concerts.
Make sure it's not a larger issue. So we'll give her a second or two while we kind of catch up.
I could talk more about my concert.
Well, you know what's fun is I actually did not realize how fast I had filled the cast. I think I have a couple of like question marks out there, but Ravenloft 1918 is like starting to gear up.
Ooh, that's fun.
Which will be
fun. What are you doing? What are you doing for guns?
Can we get a prediction and see if the cat powered down the laptop? Absolutely.
Ooh. I give it 2-1 odds.
Cat dumped a glass of water on the keyboard.
I'm going to go for a cat unplugged the internet.
Let's see. Well, that's the previous. Okay, I get it. Was Liz's DC cat related? Two minutes to vote.
I'm gonna take 30 seconds and grab my computer cord. Hang on.
Okay,
we'll
go.
Have to make sure this fate doesn't befall me as well.
She wasn't using a Cat 5 cable. That obviously was the problem.
There you go.
That was obviously the problem. Okay, so for guns, I'm looking at. I actually started playing today. Wait, she's connecting. We gotta stop her before she says anything. Don't say why you left.
Wait, there's a prediction up on.
Don't tell us what happened yet. We have to wait. We have to. They have another minute and a half to vote as to whether or not it was cat related. So we're gonna have to see what happened. A lot of people are putting lots of channel points into that, by the way.
Into the cat.
Into the vote. We won't say which way they're going yet. So we don't want your poker face to reveal anything. But no, for guns, I started playing, and my current plan is to allow hand crossbows, light crossbows, and heavy crossbows, and that would be your
just flavor pistol, them as guns.
Your rifle or large caliber gun, pistol, and then your long rifle.
Gotcha.
And that's just going to relabel them, cool. And that keeps the balance.
I play a lot of Hunt Showdown, and that's set in like 1890 something.
That makes more sense to the conversation.
Yeah, 1890, like late 1890s. And so like the 1911 doesn't exist yet. It's not that far along. Mm-hmm. All the guns are just really crap, but like very powerful. Which makes for a very interesting game. Precision is really important.
Indeed, it is.
Yeah, there's just like no automatic weapons. It's fantastic.
Yeah, a lot of it. I don't want to get in. I like the mechanics. I like a lot of the rule sets. I like all the encounters being pre-made. I'm not sure I like the amount of damage that the rule-based guns can do. So that kind of puts me in a little bit of a spot when it comes to that.
I'd be curious to see if there was any like systems out there that someone on like DM's Guild has developed or something.
Yeah, lots of possibilities. Okay, the submissions are in. Liz, was the disconnect related to the cap?
I wish it was, because that would be way funnier, but it was not the cat's fault this time.
Oh, what happened?
I plugged my computer into an outlet that apparently does not have any electricity. So the computer died while plugged in. So
that's always fun.
Dang.
Yeah, so I need an electrician, not a cat wrangler.
So everyone who voted no paid out 4-1.
Oh, wow. I think it was
really
only me.
Sad it wasn't the cat.
I think it was only you.
I think it was only me.
Nice.
Predictions are fun. You know what? Let's do another one. While we're doing them, let's see here.
I knew the cat was innocent because I speak with animals.
There we go. And up comes a new prediction. Here's a chance for you to get your points back. Is anyone going to zero this combat?
Let me see.
Check. Now, if you're not sure, check the battle board.
Yeah, check the initiative tracker as well.
And consider that Lorelai is on the roof, so.
Yeah, Lorelai is one typical Liz die roll away from sliding off the roof and taking 66 damage.
Right?
And by them, I mean the PCs.
I've zeroed out once. I don't plan on doing it again.
Obviously, the NPCs are going to zero. I hope.
Witcher coins.
Is there a way to bet faster than just clicking a million times?
I have no idea.
People are going all in with this.
I would like to.
A lot of people have a lot of channel points over here.
Yeah, fair enough.
A lot of them have
66,000.
Oh yeah. My God.
And not a lot of people have a lot of faith in us. I am offended.
Listen, the board is quite dire at the moment.
I mean, yeah.
We still have plenty of combat left to have. I'm not sure. I gave you good odds for not going down before we can take down bugbear number 3 and 5.
Oh, then guilty, sorry.
There's more combat to be had.
I believe in us, guys.
I don't use the predictions nearly enough when we're gaming either. I need to get better.
Pretty fun.
Azteki's at 156,000. He's half the reason I do pub nights now, because like I said, I don't know if we get like 60,000 points donated, I'll do a pub night. And like three sessions later, because you're only allowed a certain amount per time, my goal of pub night was met.
I want to do a pub night.
Pub night sounds fun.
Oh, I'll text you next time I'm doing one.
Right. I mean,
there's no reason not to stop now.
I even have a list ready to go.
I was going to say, I thought I saw.
The tunes I know I can pull off. Oh. So, okay, all the votes are in, submissions are closed. Let's get back at this. Chrysanthemum is currently the active player. What are you doing in this moment besides, you know, attempting to unring your bell?
I am going to hit myself with a healing word.
Now, for the record, that's a bonus action.
I think, not healing word, sorry, cure wounds is what I meant to say. I meant to say cure wounds.
You could go either way.
I said it, and then I was like, wait a minute, that doesn't sound right.
Yeah.
No, a cure wounds. Slot
you cure wounds. All right.
I'm going to use a level 1.
That's now. Reasonable.
Hey, not bad.
A little below average, but that's going to shore you up. None of them have done 12 damage in a swing yet.
No.
Yeah.
And then I'm going to And then I'm going to use my bonus action to swing my spiritual bottle of wine.
Religious alcohol. That's a thing.
Religious animate alcohol.
It is a thing.
Animate levitating, religious spinning, regenerating alcohol.
What, you never heard of church wine? Come on.
Exactly. It doesn't taste very good.
Does the reroll redemption work both ways?
I use something like really better.
Yeah.
If you have access to it, you can always force a reroll in any direction on any roll.
Well, I don't like that question.
Including you can force the players to reroll. You can force the NPCs to reroll.
It sounds
almost died from that.
Sounds like Polymorph has a vested interest to protect.
Oh gosh.
It is on cool. It might still be on cooldown though. I have the channel point one's got a pretty lengthy cooldown on it. Although the sound alert one does not. Just to say.
Sound alert.
Yeah, there's one that's on the sound alert panel. There's a reroll.
I feel like we just gave everybody an interest in us not surviving this fight.
In one of you not surviving.
Dropping to zero doesn't mean not surviving. It just means not.
The party can win. Either way, Drumir, what you doing?
Drumir is going to see if we can't thin these numbers a little bit and try and take out number 3. Just take him off the board.
Just put an arrow into him.
Yeah, I suspect we'll be able to take him down more easily than number 5. So I'm gonna try that. I can figure out where my character sheet is.
All right, there we go. The plus 5, you gotta miss.
12?
Thump, right over his shoulder, slightly.
Ah, man, these daggers were working out better. Let's see, I can...
Liz is going to be up next.
I'm going to use my movement to go 1, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. Bonus to disengage 30. Find myself positioned over here. So I basically just slide past number 3 after taking a shot at him.
Now, you're from the Midwest. Do you use the appropriate term when sliding past someone?
Nope.
Okay. Oop, just going to slide right through here.
Sneak right past you.
Sneak right past you.
It's funny. I didn't realize how often I did it until someone pointed it out to me. Yeah, I'm like, wow, that is a thing. That is such a thing.
It's really a thing.
All right, number 2 is currently fighting around the corner, so what's Lorelei doing?
I'm going to shoot at... number 3.
Okay. The one that's between Chrysanthemum and her bottle.
Yes. Yes.
That's a dangerous place to be for many reasons. Don't get between Chrysanthemum and her bottle.
Liz. The guys hate me. They hate.
Oh.
They do. They are not on your side tonight.
They're not working out in their favor.
I think last week at one point I said start using your physical dice.
You did.
Because it was
I have them.
It was not pleasant. We're not there yet. Plus, I think chat might kill me. One is currently fighting around the corner. Five is going to smash Nala upside the head.
Fair.
How many hit points does Nala have in direwolf form?
37. 37. And my AC is 14.
AC 14. We got the AC. Don't worry about that. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to do this. I'm going to add a tag. And I'm going to put your hit points on as a tag for now. And I'll just track them that way. So we keep your actual pool separate from something. So there's a tag on
there. Which is how it works as well.
Yep. So what is our dire wolf doing in this moment?
I'm going to do my best to... No one actually hit three, right?
No, we both missed.
Three is still there doing his thing. Everyone has failed to kill him so far.
Very nimble bugbear.
He's wearing a cloak of displacement, isn't he?
Doing something.
Okay, so we should try to pick his pocket first and take that, and then we'll be... Okay, but I'm actually just going to try to trip five again.
Okay. I know what's going to happen.
Something good, right?
Uh-huh. Something fun.
Oh, wow.
Jeez.
I just went off into nowhere for that one. 13, that's nothing.
That is nothing.
That's my turn.
That's your turn. That's not good. That's not good.
It's getting better at blocking wolf attacks.
Okay, so she is now there. And as she comes running up along the... She actually heads up towards the lip of the roof and then half slides down towards the corner and is prepping to launch herself back the way she came. As she does, she reaches into her belt and just throws a handful of something along the roof. And Lorelei hears a ding, 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 ding. A massive handful of ball bearings roll down the roof towards her.
Right.
I need a quick dex check, if you'd be so kind.
Of course you can.
Make it a save. Make it the save.
Dex save?
A dex save. We'll give your dice one chance to do something really awesome tonight on your behalf.
And they don't.
And they don't.
There's a party reroll available.
Well, whatever. Yeah, if you want. Fall off the roof.
I mean, if you want, you could fall off the roof more gracefully than slipping on ball bearings.
Well, now
on a
there is
roof
that. I want to do an acrobatics check to see if I can turn my fall into a launch onto number three.
Sure.
I believe that was a sure of, sure, you can try.
A three.
That's pretty rough.
Three.
The party has a reroll. They can bank.
I have a bottle of wine I can drink. Okay, that's
right. You can use it if you want. I can see you're already using the bottle.
Why not both?
You think it'll help? I don't think it'll help.
It's plus seven. It should help.
Okay.
But at this point, Come on.
Oh! That's way better.
Nat 20.
Nice.
Hey!
Nice.
Nat 20. All right. Give me your standard attack roll.
That was a well played reroll.
Whatever your weapon is. And don't forget your sneak attack damage.
Ooh. Because hey. I expect that he did not expect this.
It's like the Spanish Inquisition. Nobody expects it.
Nobody expects the rogue falling off the roof.
Falls off the roof, launches an arrow directly into his skull.
And
whoops,
that killed him.
Hey, we got him.
Yeah, you could just land right where he was standing, just epic superhero style.
Exactly, the three-point fall.
Yeah,
onto his skull.
The arrow hits him. He has time to look up, and then the half elf just takes him out as she comes in on top of that
bodily.
Talk fantastic about falling with style.
Yeah, yeah.
Exactly.
All right then.
One way to fall off a roof.
When life gives you lemons, land on a bugbear.
I think that's the phrase, yeah.
Yeah, it's the one I heard growing up. So.
When life gives you ball bearings,
fall, right.
on, a fall on a bugbear.
It's a pretty cool assist from whoever threw those ball bearings. You know, they really knew what you needed.
I know, that was really helpful of them.
I know.
We got to lift each other up in this crazy world.
I'll pin that. When life gives you bugbears, you demand to see life's manager. So what is Chrysanthemum doing as, like, her friend pirouettes down off the roof and spears the one under her, in front of her?
I'm gonna go, thanks, and I'm gonna cast, what state is this? Okay, I'm gonna cast, I think it's time for a cantrip. I'm gonna cast Sacred Flame on bugbear number 5.
Okay. He gets a, what's his save?
It's a dex.
Dex. Oh, he takes his damage.
Nice.
Finally. It's not much, but it's a little bit.
Hey, cantrips count.
Cantrips
Sacred
count.
Sacred Flame is nice because you can just be like, I don't feel like rolling, you roll. No, you do it.
True.
You do it. You do it.
And then can I use my bonus action to move my bottle next to him?
Yes. 5. I think you... Do you also? I think you can also attack.
I think you all. I think moves I also get attack.
Moves and attacks. Yeah.
Yeah. Moves and attacks. All right. So I'm gonna attack. I'm gonna swing my spiritual wine.
It's a cantrip, not a cant trip.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Cantrips are great.
It needs to actually hit.
No, I never. Oh. I never knock cantrips. Yep. Eh.
That's not gonna hit.
That is not gonna hit.
A dodgy guy.
I don't know if
I'm
chat
not rolling,
is so like
I'm just
tied
not rolling
to you,
well on my spiritual weapons
to your victory at this stage. but we'll see. Drumir has his action. If Paul is settled,
I am sorry. There's a printer thing going on, and I had a fight arcade stick on top of it.
Yes.
So. Drumir is going to peek back around the corner and notice that the rooftopped individual has made her way and is probably leaving. I am going to see if there's any chance that I can notice a pouch or a bulge in a pocket. Because my suspicion is that she came to find the exact same thing we came to find and might have already gotten it. She's on her way out. A perception perhaps to try and spot a
I'll allow a perception a check as a bonus action.
Sure. Give it a real good squint.
And the die hits the table.
Hey.
And it settles on a dirty 20.
Dirty 20.
Yeah.
Yes, actually you can see that in her fist she has a large leather wrapped pouch. That she's kind of tuck in close to her chest as she gets ready to spring across.
So, let me make sure I'm doing this right, but.
This is where we turn the camera and Paul has this like marker board with all these like 3x5 cards on it with string.
Yeah, so I am gonna cast Mage Hand right next to her and attempt to, use it to like pick that pocket, and by that pocket I mean like the thing out of her hand. I am doing this correctly. I actually have to look up Mage Hand because I'm not sure I get the action when I cast it or if I have to then do it afterwards.
Here's the murder board.
You can use your action to control the hand.
I feel like Drumir would be more.
Can't
like
attack, activate magic items, or carry more than 10 pounds.
Can use your action to control the hand.
So as a arcane trickster, I can use a bonus action, but I used my bonus action to make sure she had it, I suppose. So
yes,
I am going to use that to use my action to cast that, and otherwise, once I figure out where my board is, go back behind the party again, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, in an attempt to head her off. I know she's on the roof, but I'll try to keep distance, as it were.
Okay.
So, that's me.
That is you. That is you. Number two is still fighting. What's Lorelei doing?
Right, I'm going to draw. Short sword and dagger on the bugbear number five.
It'd have to be five. He's the only one down there with y'all.
Yeah. So we'll see if I can. Oh, wrong. Sorry. Rolling the wrong thing.
That's okay.
Oh, that's a terrible roll. Let's try.
A 16?
It should be a. Well,
16 hits.
All right.
Yeah, you can roll.
That's what I thought it was. Ooh, there we go.
They both hit.
What I see on the die and what shows up in this little window is not necessarily the same thing.
I've had that issue before as well.
All right.
Got it.
Great.
So,
and then do I get my bonus?
Yes.
Goody, goody.
Yeah, you get your damage, you get your short sword, your dagger, and your sneak attack damage.
All right. Aha, take that.
So 7 from the sneak attack. 5 from the dagger. We still need the short sword damage. We're up to 12.
Shorts. There we go.
Jeez.
So 20 damage in one shot.
Yikes.
Yikes.
Last cannon.
Forget that bow.
Yeah, I was going to say the bow wasn't doing much for you.
Yeah, Lorelei actually like pulls out her blades. She takes an elbow to the spiritual wine bottle to knock it out of the way and just kind of comes in at him. And there's a moment where like the camera just shows the back of the bugbear and blood. and then it just sort of like falls out of sight and Lorelei is just standing there. He dead.
Picture her like behind there.
Had enough. Grinning. Enough of this.
So he's toast. Twink. They're still fighting from around the corner. So what's Nala doing in this moment?
I'm gonna turn back into a dark elf and cast hold person on the person running across the rooftop.
Hey.
Yes.
That would
Can
be
you, like,
fantastic.
Not.
Nice.
Rogues are pretty awesome. Rogues are pretty awesome. Okay,
however,
we're gonna stop that.
Magic.
Switch to
That's
that.
Why I did both. Actually, yeah.
Why not both?
Okay, no less dose.
And bump. Let's see. Bump. Let me get her where I can see her. There we go. And what's her save?
12.
Okay. You cast, and there's a moment where she kind of looks down at you, and kind of like you can. There's a moment of eye contact as she does one of these at you, and then she like sideways springs across the alleyway and takes off along the roof.
Oh no!
Oh, I didn't. It didn't hold very well.
Whoa! Ugh, sucks.
And she's off.
Shit.
Who wants to give chase and how are you doing it?
Ooh, I would love to.
The combat is officially over, by the way. We're out of combat rounds. We're just going around. We're going around the table, and nobody went to zero this combat. So everyone that said no, they won't.
Wait, no, I bet against us. Damn.
Oh,
you were really low. There were two bugbears next to you.
I had this
complete prediction. Nobody went down. Ari is ecstatic.
You guys almost got me to 70k through this wanton gambling.
It was a 4-2 vote. People were banking you weren't going to.
Nice.
People were banking. True. You know, I'm going to have to actually put a troll in here somewhere for you guys to take on. Just, you know, as an homage.
It was one in the first session.
You need to bring another one back. Okay, so the woman in all black in the cape disappears down the way. How are you giving chase? If you're giving chase, you don't have to.
Should we go around?
Tell you what, we're going to go in this order. Jameer, what are you doing?
I'm going to try to... Can I see her from here?
You can see her back.
Okay. I would like to... I bet you that's too far for me to move the mage hand, but I bet you I can dismiss it, then recast it. Because it's 30 feet. But she's probably not 30... Wait.
Well, I moved you just so I could line you all up. She's like right at the 30 feet mark.
Okay. So I would like to recast Mage Hand and then use my bonus action to take the thing out of her hand.
Okay.
The way that it's phrased, it says you can perform one of the following tasks with it. You can stow one object the hand is holding in a container or carried by... You can retrieve an object in a container or carried by another creature. Does that mean I just get it?
She's actively resisting that.
Okay.
And Mage Hand fails strength checks.
It does it?
I believe I skimmed that. Let me see if I can find it again. Can't attack, activate magic items, or carry more than 10 pounds. That's why I'm assuming the strength check.
Right, yeah.
It, so more than 10 pounds of pressure overpowers the Mage Hand.
Yeah, that would be too...
You could try to get it off of her without her noticing.
I would like to do that. It does say you can perform one of these tasks without being noticed if you succeed a sleight of hand contested by their perception. So I would like to try to do that.
Yeah,
depending
go
on
for
if
it.
That goes well or not.
Sure. Sure, go for that.
That one I have trained? Yes. That's a natural one. Do we have a reroll?
You do not.
We tried.
In that case, that sucks. In that case, 5, 10. Can I get on the roof?
Just go running after her?
Yeah.
You can totally go running after her. So, keeping track, you are taking off along the roof after her.
Mm-hmm.
No problem.
Yep. Not enough action to do anything else. So.
Okay, this is our rooftop. I'm just going to put you on the rooftop as chasing after her.
Sounds good.
Is that person actually wearing a metal mask?
No. Distances are relative. I just need to know who's where for purposes of this. What is Nala doing during this, like, as she takes off?
I don't really have animals that can run on roofs super well fast. So I think I'm going to try a hold person again. I did not mean to pick him up.
Line of sight's a little dodgy.
She's
up on a roof.
Can I? Well,
you could get up on the roof and maybe catch her before she gets out of range next turn.
Let me
check the range on it. Maybe you can't. What is the range on that thing?
A house cat has a speed of 40 and a climb of 30.
House cats are freaking fast.
Giant hyena has a speed of 50.
Oh my god. It doesn't have that climb, though. The cat doesn't even need to make a check to get up on the roof. 50's a lot. Wow.
Yeah, what? If you have a move speed of 50, how high can you jump?
It's your strength. It's based on strength.
So it's a +3.
Yeah. Not quite up onto the roof, but you could get up there pretty quick. Are you?
Yeah. Then,
are you giving
that,
chase?
I'm not,
bigger question.
I mean, they're giving chase. Let's do house cat. Yeah, let's do it. I'm not gonna be able to like tackle or anything, but I could stay on her.
Okay. You can
stay on her, track her, maybe pop out and cast a spell.
So Nala comes running up behind as a cat. Okay. Duly noted. Is Chrysanthemum joining the chase?
Can I see anybody at this point?
They've disappeared down the roof.
They've disappeared down the roof. Okay.
It's a rooftop chase.
It's a rooftop chase. I'm not going to be very good at climbing the roof. I feel like that's going to be a really poor decision.
We're going to cannot turn in anything that flies right now. I know that sounds like it would be a good idea, but I'm not allowed yet.
Is there, how like blocked in is this roof? Is there any way I could like hear the direction they're running and then run along the ground?
Yeah,
alongside?
You could try. You can try to follow her along.
Okay, I'm going to try following on the ground level and kind of like keep my gaze up to see if I can catch a glimpse of anybody. Because I'm specifically looking to see if I can catch a glimpse of the runner. I'm trying to get line of sight on the runner or Drumir. Because I could hit Drumir with a healing spell if I can't do anything else.
Okay, fair enough. And then what is Lorelei doing? Last, absolutely not least.
I'm going to attempt to join the rooftop chase.
Okay. You take off down the roof after her. I need everybody to give me an athletics check.
With the house cat, do I still have to do that?
Yep.
My athletics is not good.
I need to find house cat. Because I don't know anything about it.
A roll?
No. Okay. It's a good thing I the squat nimbleness. I had the option to get proficiency with acrobatics or athletics, and I'm like, man, my athletics is -1. I should fix that.
Speaking of which, I also need a survival check from our cleric.
Survival check.
As you're trying to keep tabs as they start running along the roofs, and okay, you're just trying to keep tabs with who's out. Where, you're kind of tracking from the ground.
Oh, nice. I watched it almost land on 5 and then roll over to an 18.
Works out perfectly.
I was about to say an unladylike word.
I need to do athletics, yeah?
Nope. Yes.
Or, okay.
Yeah, we haven't got one from our house cat yet. No.
5.
Ooh. Okay. Well, that's interesting. You guys take off after her. You're gaining on
my
her.
My strength is very not good.
Which is good. You gain on her. Except that as you're running along the roof, I need a quick dex save from our cat.
Oh,
no. Theoretically, that would be something that
Yeah, I'm like, hopefully I get a +2, so. Dex. Not good.
As you're running along, Drumir like steps on a bunch of rotted roof tiles that kind of crack down behind him, and the cat doesn't see it until it's too late, and she lands on it and just poof down into the building.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Bomp, bomp.
The good news is she can rejoin the chase later. All right, another athletics check, guys.
Am I managing to keep pace with my
You are keeping pace.
Check?
You are keeping pace. Okay. You actually double caught up.
Would we be able to try some actions as we're chasing him down, or is it too hectic?
If you stop to do an action, you're going to lose sight of her.
I do have, well, shit, yeah. I was going to say, I'm like, I do have cunning action to dash, but I need that cunning action to try and pickpocket.
So does she.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
She's also a rogue.
Yeah, she's also a rogue.
Can I use acrobatics since we're now up and we're just balancing?
Nope, this is a straight up, this is a, endurance. Come on, you know the difference between being dexterous and endurance. I've watched you
this
after.
Is Dex to, this is Dex. Ooh, to stay
this
out
is
of
endurance
group.
Now. This is yours trying to keep up with her.
Oh, okay.
This is like Jillian has started, and you think you can keep up.
If this is keeping up, that's different. Yeah, I thought it was to keep up. From falling off the roof.
No, this is just keeping up.
Dex saves for those.
Or a goat. A goat would have been a better choice.
Did we get the new round of athletic saves?
A mountain goat.
We have a 5 and a 4. And then Arwen, we need a survival check. What's that mean? 19. You are definitely keeping up with her.
I'm rocking it.
Actually, I think, yeah, you're catching up with her a little bit. Unfortunately, I need a dex save from Drumir.
Not bad.
Nice save. Nice save. As you, like, you hit a thing of, like, ice and just start to slide down off the roof, and you slide right into a chimney, push off, and you're back up and running.
Nice.
Athletic right, saves, everybody.
She I is think that,
pulling away.
I think that I'm not going to be able to keep pace with her, so I'm going to try something.
Oh, dear
Do you guys think that I should try to pickpocket it again with the mage hand? Or do you think, like, trying a sleep or a charm person would probably make more sense. I only have a DC of 12, which is not
great. You
beat
my 12, yeah. But I don't know.
I think I'm going to try to do the rogue thing. I don't think I'm going to be able to keep pace with her.
Now, bear in mind, she's not 30 feet away from you. She's...
Oh, further than that.
She's got some distance on you, but you could try it. I'll always let you try.
So the range is 30 feet,
yeah.
Unfortunately.
Yeah, this is not to range. This is just for tracking the relative position.
Gotcha. Yeah, yeah. So if I'm out of range, then... I'm out of range of both of those.
Charm is that? Yeah, I think. Yeah, I would also agree with Polly. I was gonna see if we went there. I had plans, but yes, this is definitely a hostile situation.
Oh, right. Yeah, yeah.
In which case, I think I just want to shoot her.
Yeah, it might not be a bad idea.
It's a good answer.
But yeah, okay. Never mind then. We'll see if I Dwarven Fortitude can
keep up with her.
Yeah.
All right.
Although it's technically. Training and strength.
Sprinters. I am not keeping up, so I'm going to try to slow her down. So I'm going to take a shot with my bow.
Okay.
Maybe roll the it. Blood will be something for us to track her with, at least.
That is my other thought.
Blood and yeah. snow, point. Yeah.
Good point.
Girl. Although the way I've been rolling, it probably won't.
Tell you what, Liz, I mean, we'll grab see. One of those real physical D20s.
Too late.
Well, I told you to, so I'm not counting that. Roll a real physical D20.
All right. And grab one.
Everyone knows dwarves are natural sprinters.
Yep.
So what were you doing?
Hey, they're tough. They got some endurance.
What were you doing between shifts in the mines? No, oh, you know, running food down to people, working dwarf dash.
Dwarf 16. Dash.
16. Yeah, the arrow actually clips her, and she rolls. She actually takes a bit of a tumble. Rolls back up to her feet and keeps going, and you can see where there's a slice on her leg that the arrow went through. And the cat kind of pops up and starts to run over in that direction. Is Drumir continuing to try to keep pace, or are you?
Yeah, I don't think I can really do anything other than try and take her out, and I do not trust my abilities. We'll try and run her down dwarf style.
Okay.
Dwarf style.
Go, buddy.
I didn't roll it.
You got some endurance on your side.
Maybe. That's an 8. It was at a 17, and it's like...
Yeah. She's... No, it's not happening. As you're starting to, like, feel that burn, as you're sucking in that ice-cold air on top of it...
Not great.
And it's like, this is not what dwarves are meant to do. This is not... And you watch as she, like, goes around a chimney, and you're like starting to beeline for the other side of it, and she doesn't come out on it, and you look over, and there she is across, like, she's jumped across the street and is going down another series of roofs. Arwen spots her going overhead, skids, and starts to book it, and immediately slams into a party of halflings that are walking the streets singing about the beauty of snow. And she starts, you know, like, guys, Get out
of her way.
And everyone up on the roof.
Thaumaturgy.
Just
move. Princess Bride style. Everybody move.
And there's like this moment of like, and the snow. Shuffle, 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 shuffle. And Arwen, you know, hustles down the alley, turns the corner, and is immediately greeted by a massive, brightly lit theater facade.
Ooh.
And there's a station in the front that sells tickets for tomorrow night's performance. Ooh. And as you glance down, you can see there's this patch of red in the snow right in front of the ticket booth.
Is there like a trail or just a pool? I'm going to look around for like a trail.
There's a little bit of it that kind of goes over in that general direction. And you can see there's lots of footprints in all of the directions. And there's no blood going necessarily that you can trace away from it. The ticket seller looks up and goes, "Would you like a ticket? We're nearly sold out of tomorrow night's show. We just sold one of our last there a moment ago."
I'm looking for my friend. She came running through and I describe.
Oh, yes.
She tripped and fell on a rock and I think she's bleeding.
Oh, she did have a bit of a limp, but she was quite in a hurry. She purchased a ticket and took off.
Oh, thank goodness. Can you tell me which direction she went?
That way?
Okay. I'm gonna take off in that direction.
Okay. You chop, huff, 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 huff. And there's zero sign of her.
There is zero sign of her.
At this point, the party has caught up to you.
Oh. All right, where is she? Did we get her?
I'm going to sniff
bought a
perception
ticket
to see if I can
theater.
Find what direction she's going.
She bought a ticket at the theater and then I lost her. Wait, did you say she bought a ticket?
Yes. It's you can pick up a bit of a scent, but then it becomes clear she must have gone back up onto the roofs again.
What the heck did she stop and buy a ticket for?
That is super, very unusual.
There's a show tomorrow night. Would you like a ticket? There's only a few left.
What is the show tomorrow?
Tomorrow, it's quite the performance. We are doing a production of. What's the name of the show? Where's the name of the show? Oh, yes. The Blood Wedding. It's a play about love, jealousy, and death.
The best ones always are.
How many tickets are left?
A half dozen, perhaps.
Oh, okay. I turn back to the group. I'm like, I mean, it's super weird that she would be there, but.
Yeah, especially considering the fact that she stopped in the middle of a chase to buy a ticket.
Maybe that's the handoff.
Yeah, we need a ticket.
I think we need a ticket.
I think we, yeah.
I think we need however many tickets there will be players
to buy all the tickets. Right meow. Slams down a sparrow.
At the risk of metagaming. We need however many tickets we're going to need.
Coupled with in the original writing of this adventure, the rogue disappears into the theater if she gets away.
Gotcha.
And the chase continues within. But since we might not have all four of you back next week, it makes sense that we'll just, well, clearly this is where she's doing her handoff. We'll have to come back tomorrow night and ambush her.
I'm so sad at that one that I rolled on the sleight of hand.
That was perfect.
That would have been perfect.
That would have made less interesting here at the end. But we're at 10 o'clock. We're at the end of our game session, which is like
perfect.
Where I want us to get to tonight, which was a lot of fun. Thank you guys for coming out tonight. I'm glad we got to play tonight. I'm glad we got all this fun stuff. We tried to re-roll it. Polly, you've been like the sixth man on the court tonight, I think is the term we use.
Been kicking butt.
Let's see. Next week we are scheduled to have And of course, schedules can vary wildly with our groups. Malik is back. Arwin is back. Ari, if you're feeling well, you should be back. And then Spinny should be back. We're going to give Liz a week off finally.
All right.
But you are technically on standby. So if any of them have to cancel, you're back in it. And
all
I have a feeling you
might actually be all of us.
Yeah, I have a feeling you really want to take out the that rogue. Like, it's personal now.
Just a bit.
Well, no, because we want Ari to come back too. We missed having her tonight at the table. We're so glad that you were feeling well enough to hang out in the chat. It was a blast to have you hanging out with us tonight, and that mattered a lot. So thank you for that. That being the case, yes, and hopefully it's not the thing. Fingers crossed, not the thing. I don't want more of my players to get the thing. I get
thing
nervous.
It was not fun.
Yes. I get very nervous. Katie K had her 10th birthday party last night as a sleepover. She got to meet her friend from school for the first time ever.
Ever?
Yes. They've been friends virtual. They met October last year while they were virtual.
Oh, man.
They go to different elementaries, but they were grouped together because they were paired into a virtual classroom, and they became friends. And they had been
really cool.
They've been together, like, friending all through this over Zoom. And I woke up yesterday morning with a sore throat. And I'm like, oh, hex to the no. No, 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 no. I was like, I will do anything to get my hands on the COVID test. I am not risking this.
Ugh.
And it came back negative.
That's good.
Yay.
So, and here she is to say goodnight. Our newly minted 10-year-old.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Congratulations.
When is her birthday?
It was yesterday.
It was actually the 19th.
Oh, okay.
But
I was going to say we're birthday twins. My birthday's today.
Oh, happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Thanks for sharing it with us. You didn't need to do
You're
that.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
Well, what do we want to do on our birthdays? We'll play D&D.
It is quite nice.
Word indeed. Yeah, hers was back, but because somebody's daughter decided to schedule a super intensive dance camp the weekend of her birthday, we had to do the sleepover the next week so that we could actually have the fun around everything else.
I didn't make her sign up for that.
That's its own story. Okay, so let's do around the table. Who are you? Who were you tonight? Can we find you anywhere on the internet? And what was your star moment of the night? And we're going to go the round back the opposite way we came. So Arwen goes on the hot seat first.
I am Arwen Atreides, and I was playing Chrysanthemum Coriolis. Sometimes it's just fun to have combat. Sometimes it's just fun to sling your spells and try to hit stuff. And I'm actually really pleased with my first casting of Spiritual Weapon. That's going to make a reoccurring appearance for sure.
Cool. Let's see. That takes us over to Jeremy.
Hi, I'm Jeremy. I was playing Nala the Druid, and I'm mostly online here. I'm not really anywhere else right now. My star moment is when I realized that a cat is not really suited for chasing someone on a rooftop in the winter. Because it was one of those moments where I was like, I don't have any way to come back from this. That was just a bad... I shouldn't have done that.
I imagine you crashing through the roof into a very fancy tea party.
I figured,
something out of
see you later, guys. Exactly, just run and jump through a window somewhere. Like, oh, it's a bad idea.
All right, and then we come up to Malik.
Yep, I'm Malik. I'm Paul, aka Malik. I played Drewmere today. You can find me on whatever social media. It's just posted in chat there at Paul Jajo. And my star moment was, I really enjoyed all the role-playing that happened. I got to call out the cessation of combat at the butchery, because oftentimes groups just murder hobo around and like, you know what solves this problem? Killing them. I appreciate the call to like, okay, maybe we just take a step back. Everybody calms down a little bit and we can go from there. So props to that. I think that was Lorelei. Or no, I'm sorry.
It was Arwen with her thaumaturgy.
It was the thaumaturgy. That's right. Sorry. Thank you for that. That was great.
Arwen knows how to make thaumaturgy do all kinds of things that Chris Perkins never intended.
Yeah.
Thaumaturgy, I don't use it that often, but when it works for me.
It's good.
A good spell.
All right. And Liz, last but not least.
I'm Liz, and I was playing Lorelei, the rogue. And my star moment was finding out that y'all thought my cat had sabotaged my computer.
We figured it knocked a cable loose or.
Oh, I knew the cat was innocent.
My theory was glass of water.
Bunch
on
of haters.
No, I've had cats. I've had many cats, and that's why I was like, yeah, the cat absolutely has something to do with it.
Although, am I seeing that yours is playing fetch with you?
Actually, that is the dog playing fetch.
Okay. I'm like, it's not unheard of. Cats are quite clever.
Yeah, no, she doesn't play fetch. She's a really good cat, and she comes when she's called and does a lot of other dog-like things, but not fetch.
Gotcha.
As sometimes happens. Well, and then my name is Rob, a.k.a. Lantern Noir, and my star for the night, man, y'all were just fun. I don't have a lot of big ones. It was neat to see the pressure point of, like, we're still going to deliver this woman her meat. Like,
I thought that was a great idea. I was like, I don't know if we're going to go with it, but I like it.
There were lots of kind of fun things that go with this encounter. I think it's really well written. It's really neat. I will say nothing about what happened around the corner because something was happening back there and the players totally have the choice to make that a priority or not, which I think it worked out really well and it was a ton of fun to deal with in that sense. So that was a lot of fun.
Hey, we just had to make sure Chrysanthemum didn't get crushed by monsters randomly.
We got assaulted on the street in broad daylight.
In an alley in a snowstorm.
In an alley in a snowstorm. Not quite broad daylight. But, you know.
Right, but she was just standing there minding her own. Well, not really minding her own.
I mean, we were actually like tracking someone.
They didn't I wasn't getting that. Into anything. I was just kind of walking around and vibing. I wasn't like snooping.
Right. It was a random bugbear assault. We had to defend our party members. So that's, you know.
Just chilling there next to this wolf, like, or as a wolf, deciding whether to eat human flesh or not, you know.
Not the biggest near-death experience
I've
ever had.
Some ethical dilemmas this time around.
Yeah.
But the bugbears have eaten human flesh. I could just ask them, but, you know, they're dead now.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I meant to ask, what did Nala, was there, like, other non-bovine flesh in that bakery? Had she really been getting those deliveries?
Yeah, I mean, she gave me a scrap of meat that was her own meat, and it was also human flesh.
I thought it was from the bag.
That's why I wanted her to. That's why I wanted Nala to go in there to see if that's like.
If it was also, yeah. Ooh. I was like, ooh, that's not good.
Very.
But
reasonable.
I don't think, like, as far as like, I don't think she knows that it's people.
Well, yeah.
I mean, there's all kinds.
Soylent Green confirmed.
In Waterdeep.
Right.
We have lots of choices tonight for where to go. I'm thinking as we wrap up here and we send you out somewhere, unless someone wants to steer the raid, I think we're going to drop in on the Reluctant Hermit tonight. I still am optimistic. Yay. I can get him to the table. And he's rocking quite the time. He's trying to finish up Legend of Zelda, one of them. So we'll just throw him some fun. I need to, Breath of the Wild. I, at some point, need to create a raid command for y'all. So everyone that's got a sub can use our fun emotes when they arrive. And But either way, wish him well when you get there. Thank him for being the awesome person. I'll be back for sure on Tuesday. I am going to be premiering Waylanders, which is a new real-time with pause party-based fantasy RPG. So, yes, I'm really geeked to show it off. Hoping my code comes tomorrow so I can make sure everything works so I can get the longest stream to support them. But it should be a good time. Also, I hope I like it. I'm a little nervous taking a free game, and then maybe I don't like the game. But we'll see. And then Wednesday, we are back with the Convergence, and they are continuing all kinds of wackiness there. They've encountered another Forge Cleric by reputation, and so that's being a lot of fun. And then Kitty K has me on the hook to sometime this weekend do a crafting stream where we are going to make a poppin' cookin'.
Ooh, that sounds fun.
Which are the little... They are the little packages you get from Japan where you make fake food out of sugar.
Okay.
She really loves them. She and her friends burned through like 8 of them this weekend. So I'll get you out of here. Say hello to the hermit for me. Until the next time we all get together and play, please, wherever you are and whatever you're doing, stay safe.